Apparently, it's not like taken from the books, but it's based on them, yeah. So yeah, I don't know if you guys have been watching other people play this or, but I saw like some people posting about it on Twitter. Maybe those people were watching the people who stream it play it. It just works out like that sometimes. Hey, Mandy. Mandy, do you have to spray Dave like so he doesn't smell like pickles constantly? You have to spray him down? Hair looks electric. Okay, let's see if we can fix the filter a little bit today. You have to be careful because it's daytime. See, this is the problem. This brightness comes in from the left. That's a little better. Is that a little better? A little better. I have to figure out the lighting of my new place. I should have maybe put my desk somewhere else, but it's perfect where it is. This is the perfect spot for it. Smoothness just makes you disappear. Key color reduction, I don't do anything. Turn the brightness down. No, it doesn't do anything. Anyway, so we're in. This is only our second quest in this one. We did the vampire quest. Now we're trying to get this company to not chop down the final chocolate plant for a time police girl. The stream capture that was on main Twitch follow page looked good. Hey, Sopiak. Hey, Space Hopper. Is this me? What? People looking at someone weird playing a Steam Deck? Pretty accurate, yeah, Dave. Yeah, the key spill of Miguel is green, right? I just don't want curtains. I don't like having like a big bunched up curtain. You know? I don't want curtains. Also, it would be annoying because it's a gigantic window. It's a double gigantic window. When we last left you, you were taking a tramp through the Brazilian rainforest. So again, the story is we're trying to get this pencil company to not chop down the rainforest because they inadvertently chopped down the best cocoa tree and the best cocoa plant. The last one in existence that has the best chocolate. And this time police girl from the future, she's a time cop. She took us back in time to try to save the best chocolate plant. This is a sci-fi pun game. Like, where's the pun? This one?
Is that a miner?
No, yes. It belongs only to itself.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is that a miner?
No, it belongs only to itself.
Is that a miner? No, it belongs to itself. Whoa. Whoa. Okay, what do I want to do? Maybe I want to take off. Okay, what do I want to do? Is that a miner? There's a really... If you want to know how punny this game is it this one?
Hey, Scram. We don't serve miners here.
There was a really crazy pun here.
Hey. I just got a great idea. Let's catch that bird, take it back to the States, put paint on its feet, let it walk around and create a big painting for us.
Careful, you could be charged with transporting a mina across the border for a mural purposes.
See? That's how punny this game is. Put paint on the feet of a mina, you get in trouble because for transporting a mina across the border for a mural purposes. This game has so many puns in it. It's the most punny game in existence.
Notice that monkey?
Yes.
He keeps following us. He's been following us for the last quarter hour.
Maybe he's looking for Reese's Pieces.
Or chocolate chimp cookies.
Or lemon meringue-tang pie.
Well, let's not scare him away. I've come all the way to Brazil. I don't want to do San Simeon too.
See what I mean? film on the window?
Mm-mm.
Curtains are too much like decorations. Mm-hmm. They have a green screen at a perfect angle. Yeah, well, I don't think that's gonna work because, yeah. I thought about that, I tried it. Do I have a good view? Not really, I mean.
It's like some woods.
It's like wooded. It's not like a crappy dump or anything.
There's like some woods out there, which is kind of nice.
Yeah, it's decent. It's like if you like looking at woods, I like looking at woods. Hey, petit chéri, bonjour. Perfect timing. Yeah, we start streaming an hour early, but I'm going to stop streaming an hour earlier, unfortunately, now. The floor is a pandemonium of color, startling and bright, and found nowhere else in the world except Holiday Inn. Pick the purple plant, start the pollen leaf, and find it to be amazingly sticky. You finally manage to disentangle yourself, leaving a dark green sticky residue on your hands, which you wipe in your thighs until the residue has been mostly transferred to your pants. Okay, good. This fern? You pick a fern and give
Goodness,
it to Josie.
Let me see if I have something to put this in.
Okay. We need to find the chocolate plant, or we need to do something with this monkey, or spank the monkey. This displeases the monkey greatly, but leaves you strangely satisfied. Talk to the monkey. You do your best Dr. Doolittle impression, but the monkey isn't buying into it. Spank the monkey. Smell the sky. It smells like a greenhouse. Okay, I think we're looking for the chocolate plant at this point. Can't catch the bird. Oh, we can go forward. Hold on, I'm gonna go back, though. How do we go back to where we were? I didn't finish exploring there. Maybe we don't need to. Yeah, there's just so many things to click on, and there's, like, multiple puns. There's not just one pun per object. There's multiple puns per object. It's ridiculous. An old handmade urn half full of sand sits at the base of the stairway. You comb through the sand, but other than a fair amount of sticks, dust, and non-sand particulate, you dredge up nothing out of the ordinary. The urn's far too heavy to be carried. Empty it? Let the sand stay in case there's a modern city built here and there's a snowstorm. Okay, read. There are symbols on the urn.
I'm not sure what it is this civilization smoked, but whatever it was, this is where the butts went.
Alright. It's just puns all over the place. Yeah, ridiculous puns. Rock formation. Urn lid. Move the urn lid. Reach down and pick it up. You see several dirty cracks. You leave it alone. Can we go up here? Into the temple? Oh, we went into the exterior. Now we're... Wait. Can we go this way? Oh, we can look up. The vines. Vines and ivy hang in profusion over the front of the temple. Move the vines. You go to the front of the temple, pulling the vines. Josie joins you, and you're able to remove the vegetation, revealing a bas-relief and subtle but brilliant color. Read the mural. Can't read it. Never paid attention in Aztec class. Josie looks up to get it, moves up to get a closer
it's
look.
It's similar to Tupi, and I'm a little rusty on my Tupi. You're not going to grade me on this, are you?
Not till we get back to Callahan's, anyway.
This has got to be it. The people here called themselves Yora, and they worshipped this cacao tree.
Worshipped chocolate?
That's not so surprising. The Guatemalans used it for money at one time, and only royalty was entitled to it.
Cacao. Okay, let's go. Wait, this is where they worshipped. Can I go up in there? Oh, open the doorway. There's no knob, no handle, no keyhole. The oblong stone is entirely featureless. Figure out a way to get in. Let's see, the pedestal. Approach the pedestal. Oh, what's this? Easy, medium, hard, medium. Oh, it's, can I escape and then do hard? Hard. Okay. What do we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, let's see. 4, 7, 9, 11, 5, 7, 8, 10, 11, 3, 6, 9, 11. 3, 6. Okay. What's the lit up one mean? I know how to play this. I know what this is. Wait, I don't know. Wait, why is it three different? Oh, I can't tell. I can't see the difference in the colors. This is a tough one. Let's take for here. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay. Okay. So that would be. Oh, so I have to change the colors of the stones. One, two. Wait, not that. Oh, it's got multiple colored stones. One, two. You have to keep changing the stone color. Or can I just grab it? That makes it easier. One, two. Oh man, this is quite difficult. This is not just a normal Picross. I'm gonna reset. Reset. This is not just normal Picross. Give me help. The mosaic looks like a puzzle of ancient origin that is played even today. The object of the puzzle is to form a simple picture by placing the colored stones into the proper squares on the grid. Not every square on the grid will be filled. Some will be empty. Some will have black stones. Some will have green stones. And some, too, will have gold stones. To pick up a stone from the bowl, click on it. You can also mark a stone as empty. Yeah. Okay, I see. You have all the information you need. Yeah, it's like Picross. I'm a Picross master. But this is different than normal Picross. This is much different than normal Picross. Yeah, I already know how to play. I know how to play Picross. Don't stop yelling at me. That's too many helps. Okay. So if you let's look at a really big one. You want to look at the biggest one we can. What was it? 15? Across is 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 22. So it's 22 across, and what was it? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. So 22 by 15. That's crazy. 20, 3, 6, 15, 18, 20. 20 by 15. 3, 6, 15. It's 20 by 15. That's crazy. Okay, so so this one, this whole row only has one black stone. Okay, let's see. What are these? What are the biggest? What are the biggest ones here? Yeah, it has even more puns than the Xanth game. This game is like this. So many puns. It's insane. It's pure insanity. I mean, Xanth has puns, but this has puns. 4, 8, 11, 4, 8, 10, 11, 8, 10, 13, 8, 10, also 13, 8, 10, 13. So 13 is like the biggest I see. 7, 10, 12. So 13. Okay, where do you even start here? Where do you want to start? Where do you even start? So if it's okay. So if this one's all black, right? Then that means these end with black, but these don't. So none of these would be where that goes. Because those end with green, right? It's a little hard for me to see, but these end with green. So green is not going to be in this row. I mean, black is not going to be in this row. It's going to be green. So also same with this, this, and this, 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 and this, and this. So there's four. This means there's four in a row. So that also means you don't get four from two. So that means there's definitely going to be a black one here and here. And it's either going to be these, that it's going to either be these two. These two are these two. Okay, which means that this has a two in a row, which means that that is that, and then you fill in that whole row. This is also going to be a blank because this has one black and one gold. So it doesn't have any in a row, so we can black that off. We can block that off or black it off, whatever you want to do. We still don't know what's down here. You hated this? Oh, I love Picross, and this seems like a good take on Picross too, so this might be fun. So the same deal with this, we can kind of do that with this too. What doesn't end with green? This doesn't, so we can block that off. I might get this wrong, but we can block that off because this is going to be a green. We can block that off. We can also block that off. Yeah, I've never actually seen the multiple color Picross before, so that's kind of cool. That's green, right? Okay, so now that we've blocked those off, now we can kind of look like. After you block enough off, you can start figuring out where things will go. So like this row here, now you have 2, 3, 6. We know that that's a black one. So we know that this is 1, 2, 3. We know that. We also know that this is now going to be two of the gold ones, which also means that this is going to be one gold and one black. So this row's done. Wait, hold on. No, wait, what happened? I don't know what happened, but this is actually how it goes. Wait, what happened here? Oh, that's a one in a. Because there's no gold here. I hope I didn't mess anything up, but I'm pretty sure this is how it goes. Okay, and this is a blank. Can I just. Okay, the arrow's a blank. Okay, so now we know the four is not here, so the four doesn't go through that one. It's not Sudoku. It's called Picross or Pick. I forget what the forget what it's called. I forget what its other name is. All right, so anything that starts with a green would not be where this black one is. So these all start with greens. So that's not where the black ones. I feel like I messed something up here, but I forget what. All right, so it's definitely a black one here. So this is all correct. So we're able already to rule out to finish all these rows. And now we have 16, right? So these are already only like 13. Now these rows even have 15. 15 left. So what was this? 6, 8, 10, 12, 13. And this is 15, so we can almost kind of, if we looked at it, we could kind of figure it out. So 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, and then you have the 6 could either be starting here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or you could shift it over 2. So these 4 are black in the middle here, in between the 6. The 6 is either
Absolute crap.
crap. Wait, hold on. No, it could start here, right? Because 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2. Okay, it could start here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's these four. So it's either, this is not, so the 6 is either here or here. It's either here or here or in between. So this is definitely those black ones go there. We have people to do the same here. Yo, Mudmore, what's up? Thank you for the 6 months. Absolute crap. Picross? Yeah, I keep buying all the Picross games. You buy them on the Switch. These squares tell you what pieces you want, and in this one they're also colored. Normally they're not colored. So you'll have one green, one black, and one green somewhere in this row. And you have to figure out where based on the combination of this row has six green, one black, one green, one black, one green in that order. So if you have a black one here, then you know that, and there's a yellow one here, then you know that the other two black ones are right next to it, so you can line them up. Now we have to figure out where those six greens go. If you have a limited number, you can sort of still place like the middle and then figure out where the other ones goes based on the other go based on the other rows. All right, let's see. So we got that. Let's see, can we place this six? So we have one, 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 two, one, 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 and then a six. Two, three, four, five, six. The overlap here, three, four, five, six, is these. So there's definitely three greens here, here, and here, but we just don't know where the other three greens are yet. It could be any combination, but there's definitely three greens there. I hope if I didn't mess up. Okay, this is 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, and then another 6 starting here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So same deal. Same deal. Same deal, yeah, because these are 2. So this is the same deal. It's 3 greens here. We just don't know where the other 3 are yet. So now you have a 1 followed by a 2 in these rows. So it could either be this 1, 2, or it could be this 1, 2. It's probably the first one, which means, because if it's this, yeah, actually, there's probably a way to do this. If the 3, you could do 3 green, a 1, black 1, a green 1, a black 1. That doesn't work. So this is definitely, and then you have the black 1, the green 2. The black one and the green two somewhere, the other black one and the other black two somewhere down here. This can't be the bottom black green two and the bottom black one because you can't fit two green, one black, one green, one black, and a three. So this is the first set of green two black one, which means that You're fitting one green, one black, and then the green three is up here in these first four squares. So you put the two, and then it's either green three here or green three here. Green three here, black one, green one, or green three here, and then a black one and a green one just above that somewhere. You don't know where the spaces are. Mudmore, thanks for the 4 months. 6 months, Mudmore, thanks for the 6 months. You're a ram shit. Nice. Thank you, Mudmore, for the sub. Sorry, I missed it. Jesus Christ, thank you for the 7 months. Thanks for subbing. Yeah, we're married now. And we're going to get a divorce soon, so hope you got some money saved up to pay me in the divorce. Jesus Christ, thank you. Yeah, yeah. So this is a unique twist on it, because normally it's not multiple colors. All right, so that's that. So now we have, in this row, you have a green three, a black one, and a green three. So you could have green three here, a black one, and then a green three anywhere. Or it could be a green three. So the green three could not go 1, 2, 3, 1, and 1, 2, 3, because there's not enough space. So you know that the green three, at least, is 3, 1, is, you know that that one has to be a three. It's either three this way or three here, but it cannot be here. It cannot be here. 3, 1. So you know that it is either here or here. And then there could be a one and another green three here. So you know that that has to be a green. And now you also know that this is a green three here or a green three here. That could be a black two. We can't fill any other ones there. This is really complex though. This is pretty complex. It's a huge board. So this is a pretty tough one. What else can we fill in? Because of the colors, it makes it a little bit easier because it's such a huge board, but it also makes it difficult. Actually, let's go back to here. I know that this is a black because the black is a two. Now, that means that this is a green one. Because it's a green one and then a two blacks, and that's a green one and a two black there, which all, so because now this is a black seven and one green, unless I screwed up, it's easy to screw up. That means that this is actually just gets filled in with seven blacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that fills in that row. Unless I screwed something up, that's correct. We don't know where the green six goes. We also, if this is the case here, then we know that this is, green five, and we fill in that row as well. Now we also know that this is a green two, because it's this one starts with green two, this one starts with green two, this one does also, and also this one does. So we can fill in these spaces, which means that this is the green six. We fill in that whole row. This goes one green, one black, one green, one black. Okay, the six, two green, one black, two and two. We still don't know. Two green, one black. Two green, and then a seven. So if the two greens are here, you have 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are filled in as blacks for sure. Okay, this interface even works pretty nice the way they let you use your last piece. I mean, we could put on some music while we do this part. We could put on some game music. Okay. How you doing, Liate 2? You keeping the dress? You can keep the dress. I'm fine with that. Okay, so now that we know that these are... So here's the 1, 2, 1. Well, these are 1, 2, 1, so we just know that the green is somewhere down here. The two greens are somewhere down here. We can't fill anything else down here. Let me look at this row here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. We can't fill anything else in here. So now we've blocked off. It was 20, now it's 14. No, it's 20, now it's 13. So do we have any 13s? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? We might be able to fill this one in. If we go 1, 2. If we go 1, 2, 1. 1, 2, green 2, black 2. Then these two here are definitely greens. Okay, if we go 1, 1. Green, black, green, green, black, green, black. Same deal. We have two greens here. Definitely two greens, which means we have two greens in a row. Okay, so the only two greens in this row is right here, and there's a black, and a green above it, which means that we can just fill those in right away because there's only four spaces above it. My problem is if I'm not seeing a color right and I screw it up. Okay, so let me just have two different other ones down here. Okay, so now we have the green here. It could be green, black, green. That could work, or it could be anywhere else. So we filled that in. We get a black. Okay, so now we have... This could be a three. We have a three at the end that's a green. And it's detached from this previous three that's a green. We also... Now we also know that this is all empty. The three is either here or here. Then this could be black. And we also know that the three is either here or here. And this one could be black. This one could be empty or green. This one could be black. This one could be black. This one could be green or empty. And this one could be green. Okay. All right. So now that we have a green here, play through the witness. Hey, Targor. The walkthroughs say this puzzle is easy. Well, I did put it on hard. I didn't realize it would be this hard, but I think we're able to solve it. We might as well. All right, now that we know that... Okay, we can do something here, but we can also do something here. Let's do something here first. So this is either 1, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, or 1, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. So that means we can fill in this one and this one, because it's either 4 here or 4 here. And the 1 is somewhere up here, which means we can now know that these have nothing in them. The 4 is either here or here, and the 1 is either here or here. We don't know which one yet. Okay, now we can also fill in another black square here, because the 6, the end of this is 6, and it doesn't go further than there. Same with those greens. The 6 is either here, these 6s. The 6 is either here or here. So we can fill in the 5 pieces. We have 7s, this actually helps us a lot. This is pretty big, because the 7 is either going to be here or here. 7... 2, yeah, so the 2 is either here or here or here, the second green. And the 7 is either here or here. The 7, 2, 1, 2, okay, yeah. Let's look at this here. You got 2, 1, 1. Actually, I'm gonna do this part up here first. So the first thing in here is a 6, so that can't fit up here. So we can block off the top because no pieces can fit up here. So we can block all those off too, which helps us for this 1-1-1 later on. We still can't really do this row or this row or this row. Okay, now let's go back to what we so the same deal here, like these are blocked off because the end of these rows are large pieces that will not fit. There's not ones, so we'll go over there. Hey Slightly, how you doing? How's the news place? Can you see me cooking bacon? Not from this camera angle, but I'll put a camera in the kitchen so we can do bacon. So we can cook bacon. Yeah, behind me is just a wall. You can maybe see my gamer shelves. I might stop using a green screen because of the lighting in here.
It's locked.
Hey, Andrew. Thanks for the raid. How you guys doing? What's up, Andrew? Andrew's playing Red Alert today. If you guys don't know Retro Sland Gaming, also known as Retro Island Gaming, also known as Andrew, also known as Island Guy, great retro streamer, one of the best on the platform, another retro PC streamer who came to Twitch and is doing awesome. So definitely check out Retro Island Gaming if you don't know him. What's up, Emicat? Hey, Nomad. What's up, LibJ Libertine? Hey, Mr. Steel Rose, Pork Chops. My name is Hans. My name is Hans. If you like sound effects, you're going to love Retro Island Gaming channel. We have sound effects on this channel now, too.
My name is Hans.
Andrew, what's up? Wispia. Nuke for Prez. Grunkuru, how you doing? Irem. Adore Helm. Master Gregor. Bonquin Mora. Fishhawk. Valehuhu. MP. Nepal, hello. Awesome Hans. Phone, Shrumster. Regular Obi. I'm copying off of you. We play this all the time now. Starting now. Mr. Gregor, Alams, Wispy, Poly Oddity. Aram. What's up? What's up, Andrew? How you doing, man? Adventure Joss. Thanks for the raid, man. I appreciate that so much. Thank you so much for the raid. How was Red Alert today? Did good?
I'm 31 years old.
I like the high pitch Hans. High pitch Hans makes me laugh. Is that off of from Simpsons? Is that on YouTube or did you like make that one? Oh, I don't high pitch Hans from The Simpsons. I guess it's not on here easy to find. Anyway, yeah, we are doing Callahan's and we're in the middle of a puzzle. We're in the middle of a puzzle, but we're doing pretty well. Thank you for the raid. Everyone, welcome in. So Andrew did good with the Command and Conquer. I would like to try those someday, but I suck at them. I really suck bad. All right, two greens, one black, one green, one black, and then seven starting here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two. Cut these off. These are all going to be greens. This is Picross, but it has three colors if you're into Picross. Two. This is a black, and then we have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three. Cut off the three. These are all going to be greens. All right? You guys like Picross? I love Picross. Do I feel retro in gaming? Is encroaching on my niche of close-cut stubble men and wizard hats playing old PC games? The more the better, that's the way I see it. The more the better. Yeah, for a while on Twitch, I was like, why are there not more people playing PC games? There was like no one doing it. So I always wanted there to be more. And so I'm really happy to see more people doing it, like Dr. CDCS and Retro Island Andrew and yeah, but I kind of do wish there were even more Ifrit. There need to be more close stubble people, you know, short hair. What's up, Nomad? How you doing? It's fine. That's how it is. You sucked. You focused on draining the computer of resources. Oh, you came up with a strat. I only played them for one day, and I played them for like a little bit each, or a few days, a couple of days. I just tried all the Command and Conquers on screen, on stream. Hey, Pudding Cup. Yeah, I have weird lighting in this place. I have weird lighting. I have to figure it out. I just moved into a new place, so I have to figure out the lighting. Let me see. What if we turn this down? Okay, let's try this. That's good. We're not gonna fix the green screen. The green screen's gonna be broken until I have the time to fix it. That's good enough. Stream enough DOS games, you get a free wizard hat. No, they have to be puzzle games. Okay, this one we also know the last is a green, and we know the black is a three. Yeah, thanks Andrew again for the raid. Da, 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 da. This is kind of a ridiculous. This is a really good challenging puzzle. Thanks, Pudding Cup. Yeah, I know my green screen's messed up with my new lighting. You can try to, My name is Hans. I'm 31 years old. My name is Hans. You can try to raise it a little bit. We can try to fix it slightly, one percentage at a time. Here we go. I gotta fix the lighting in my new place. All right. So we filled in some of these holes, eh? We filled in that hole, eh? Let me know it's a two, a one, and a two. So we can't do that one. We can't do this one. We can't do this one. We can't do this one. But you know the one, we're narrowing down where that one goes. That four could still be here or here. Two, one, two, two. And then the four is either there or there. Okay. A one, two, a one, one, two, one, two. Okay, now we actually ran out of enough room here. So we can do green, black, green, green, black, green. Okay, so yeah, I wanted to double check. But yeah, we ran out of enough room so that we now know that that's what this is, and that's a blank. Okay, yes. This and it works with this row. Okay, so that's a blank. Okay, perfect. Did we run out of room here too? Green, black, green. Yes, we did. We ran out of room here too. So this just initially looks harder than it actually is. You can, but you have to be good at Picross. I wonder how it is on the easy. Uh-oh, we screwed something up. Because this is green, black, green. Black, the next is black. Oh, yeah, this is a black. Okay, that's okay. No, we're okay. I just screwed that up, but we fixed it. Okay, we're okay. We're okay. Thanks for streaming PC games like Elvira, whatever the F this is. Oh, this is Callahan's Cross Time Saloon. It just has. It's mostly a pun adventure game. Hey, Refraction. It's mostly a punny adventure game that's actually really cool, but This is really the first puzzle other than the word puzzles we had before. It's not a Picross game, no. This is a puzzle inside of a really, really punny adventure game.
My name is Hans. My new windows have ruined my life. I can't fix my green screen. Years old.
Okay, now we know this is going to be a 6. And this is going to be a green 2 and a black 2. Alright. Now we know this is a black and then the 7 is here or here. 2, 1, 2. Okay, the 2 could be here or here, so we don't know the answer to this one yet. But we do have... Okay, now that we... Now, see, this is a 5, 2... Green 5, black 2. So only the green 5 only fits here, followed by a black 2, followed by a green 2, and a black 1, and a green 1. So we can fill in this whole row. Now, also... What is this song? Welcome to Yoshi's Woolly World? This is quite a song. Alright. Okay, now... Okay. 2 and 2. The 7 is either here or here. 7 is either here or here. 2, 1, 1, 1. 7 is either there. Okay. Hold on. Okay, this is a 2, a 3, and then a 6. So there's greens, but we only have six in a row of greens. So it means we can fill this in, and this is a 6. We're done with that row. Okay. The 1 is either here, here, or here. Okay, if it's here, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If it's here, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If it's here, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which means we can fill in all of these because those are the overlapping pieces, but it's not going to be here, so we can black out that piece. And then we have a 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. It's not going to start with one. It doesn't start here. We know those twos up here, which means this one's a green. The two is it here. 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And these are all blacked out. So we can black out those, which means that we can now put it. No, we now know that there's a green here. Does this make any sense at all? A 2, 2. And the green is either here or here. We've got a. Thanks again for the raid, Andrew Island. Andrew Island game. Okay. So I think the 3 has to be here because these. This is more of an advanced technique. Paranoid, how you doing today? What's going on? This is more of an advanced technique, so that's not really advanced, actually. What's up, Free Beer? I played all the Picross NDS and 3DS. No, it doesn't need to be a gap. No gaps. Okay, there's a gap if you are playing normal Picross, but with the colors, there doesn't need to be a gap. So that's how they sort of change the game, which is actually clever if you're like, if you like Picross. Hey, Super Ninja Desu. So we're almost done here. So this is going to be a 2 here or a 2 here, followed by a 1, a 2, a 1, and a 2. Cool. But now we have 2 greens. Okay, we're going to handle this. There's 2 things. Let's handle this first. So this has a 3 black, followed by a 2 green, followed by a 1 black, followed by a 2 green. Okay, so did I screw anything up? I may have screwed something up. Hold on, this row, something ain't shaking out right in this row. 3, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1. Okay, so this has to be, you can't have a 3 here. Okay, so this has to be 3 black and a blank and 2 greens. Yeah, okay, that has to be that. Okay, that means this is blank because this is a 4 either here or here. That is a 4, so we can black out that space. Okay, what was the other row I was going to do? I don't remember. This one, the green can be either here, but the green can't be here because each space is by itself here. So the green cannot be here, so we can black that out, and we can put the 2 here. Which means that's a 3, you can black out that space, and that's a 3. Now we know that that's a 3. This starts with a green, so you can't have a green and then a black 4. So that's the top. We can black out these two. We can black out these two. Okay, now we also know that this is the black 4, which starts, which goes after the green. This row's done. I wish it left that up so I could see if I made a mistake. If I... 1, 4, 2, 1, 2, 1. Okay. Good. Even if you make a mistake, it gets rid of that, which I don't really like, but that's okay. Now we know that these are going to be a green 4. Let me just make sure I didn't make a mistake. 4-1-1-1-2-1-1. Okay. Good. This starts with a green 2. Followed by black 1. 2-1-2. It can't be 2-1-2-1. So this is 2-1-2-3-1. Okay. This is going to be... we don't know where the green one... Okay, we're getting there. All right, this is going to be a block. This is going to be blocked off. It could be green, black, green. Yeah, this is blocked off. So this is just green, black, green. And then that row is done. This is black followed by a 4. The green could be here. The green could also be here. Green, black, green, black. This cannot be a black, so the 4 is here. Block off that row. That row's done. That row's done. We've got a 4. Black, green, black, green. Okay, so black. We pretty much have solved it at this point. I don't know where the other ones are. We got green, black. It's got to be a green here. That row's done. Green, black, green, black. Thank you for the clip, Master Gregor. Thank you. Yes, thank you very much. I love every clip. Oh, it's like a leaf. It's like making a leaf here. Okay, so we can pretty much guess by what the design is here, because it looks like it's a pretty regular design. But whenever you do that, you can screw yourself up in Picross. So I'm gonna follow the Picross rules and still follow the directions here, but we're just about done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7, 2, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1. Green, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, followed by a green 2. All right, we're just about done. We got 4, 2, 4, a black 1, and a green 2, and then hopefully we'll get this right. If I screwed up, I'll cry live on stream. Black and green. Okay, we did it. We did it, 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 we got it. We nailed it. Okay, now put the sound in from the game. Hey, cat peasant. Look, we did it. We got it. We got it. Did we do it? What's the gold stuff? Once the last stone clicks into place, a long unused system of weights and counterweights goes into operation. The massive stone slides slowly into the ground, heavy thudding vibrations rocking the entire temple and making your feet itch. Yeah, just do that on easy if you're not a pro, like, if you're a pro. If you're not a Puzz Wiz. Like me. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that clip, Gregor, thank you. Got that clip. Saved that clip. No, not everyone likes Puzzles, Galaxy Ghoul. Paranoid, how are you today? You forgot to turn on the gas when you're trying to boil water. You gotta have the gas on. You gotta have the gas on if you're gonna boil water. Unless you're using electricity. Yeah, it's a leaf. Yeah, don't forget to turn the gas on. I wonder what happens if somebody locks the door from the outside. Alright, we can go in. We can go in. Yeah, this is a very, very punny game. This is more puns at a... This is a Legend adventure game. Andrew on his stream showed Deathgate yesterday. So this is by the same people who made Deathgate. And it's the same interface, actually. It's basically the same interface as Deathgate. They have a lot of... Legend has a lot of different games. With different kinds of interfaces. This is the same as Deathgate, but this is more complex than Deathgate. Way more complex. Or there's like way more to this game than Deathgate. Not that Deathgate's bad, but yeah, this is basically the same engine, but like blown out and tons of puns in here. Since it's complete insanity. Cross the threshold and into another time for the second time today. You and Josie cross the threshold into the temple. The air is cool and faintly sweet, not nearly as musty as you anticipated, probably because of the open doorway on the other side of the room. The low ceiling feels as if it's designed for people shorter than you and who like to climb stairs more than you do. We're trying to save the most delicious chocolate plant. We're back in time. This Josie's a time cop, and we went back in time. We're just like a regular dude we met at the saloon that she hangs out with at the saloon. You hang out with 5 different people and do stuff for them in this game that you meet at Callahan's Crosstime Saloon, which is like a sci-fi kind of bar place. The stone floor is uneven and difficult to walk on.
It ain't no Sphinx.
Now those guys really knew how to build an ancient ruin.
But you're just like a regular guy and you meet all these aliens and stuff like that and go back in time to save the best chocolate plant from being deforested by a pencil company in this mission. The other mission was to help a vampire to stop from wanting to walk in the sunlight. And I don't know what the other three are yet. See, when your parents told you how important it was to take a second language, you laughed at them. Who's
this
laughing now?
This looks like a repeating pattern.
I'm sure the designs have some significance, but I don't recognize these symbols.
Dun, 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 dun. Hey, Cascon, what's going on? You make your boiled water with heat? You gotta do use something. Good boiled water recipe? Yeah, I put water in the pot, I put it on the burner, and then I turn the burner on to almost all the way up. But I have to keep an eye on it, because it'll boil over. Okay. Look at the carving. One of the temple's anteroom features an elaborate carving. Good. Eye socket? Oh, do we need to get... You stick a finger in the socket, there's nothing inside, but the bottom of the socket seems to have some give, as if part of the rock were on a spring. What items do we have? Naval jelly, a wrench, medicine kit, which has matches, gauze, morphine in it. We have a bamboo pole, like a blow dart gun. We have a nutcracker. We have gold stones. Put them in the eye sockets. You put the stones in the eye sockets as the last stone clicks home. A remarkable system of counterweights and pulleys triggers a hidden lock, allowing the top and bottom portions of the mural to separate. TJ, how you doing? Hello, good afternoon. Yeah, Callahan's is hard to explain, but the game, if you like puns, you'll love this game. If you hate puns, you probably won't. You will not like this game. Because it's all puns. There are parts where there's like dozens and dozens of objects in the environment that you just look at, and each one has multiple puns associated. All right, let's go in.
Oh, good. That last room was a little gloomy.
Yes, definitely cheerier in here.
What's that smell?
Not sure. Something's burnt.
When is Charles Manson? We're playing as Jesus, Charles Manson, Lumberjack. Yeah, take your pick, really. Take your pick. Bellows. Take the bellows. You take the wooden hide construction.
I think it's a bellows for the fire. At least it used to be.
Doom, 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 doom. Should I try to fix this green screen or just leave it alone? Doom, doom. That did not fix it. Dun, 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 dun. Can you use tape on walls? No, that wouldn't work. That wouldn't work. Okay, let's not fix it, because I'll spend too long trying to fix it. I could just take it down. I could just take it down. Yeah. Just take it down. Maybe I think we'll just take it down for now. Take it down. Ouch. Just sit in front of it. I can take it down. It's fine. It's completely fine. We can just take it down. I don't want it to block the game though. Let me make it somewhat smaller. Let me like hide in this void. Give it a little borders. Some borders. That doesn't matter. There. We'll just take it down. Okay. This game rises up to your favorite adventure game, Cellular Peptide. At first I was like groaning at the puns, and then you just get used to it. Half asleep, eat something or just skip the dinner. Eat something! You can't skip dinner. Eat a little, eat some corn nuts. Altar, lie on the altar. You tempt fate by lying on the altar, but neither an evil demon nor Harrison Ford appear to liven things up. A ghastly face is carved on this flat-top slab. That was my nickname in high school, flat-top slab. And you can still see some stains in the surface.
Who's this guy? If it is a guy.
Ernest Borgnine?
Red screen? Maybe that'll work. Ernest Borgnine over here? Bellows. Use the bellows with the altar. Sugar cane? Get the sugar cane on the altar? Altar doesn't require sweetening. This is a pretty long game, too. All you can gather from the murals is that they're cuckoo for cocoa pods.
Josie, can you translate?
Well, not without doing a thorough reading of the mural out in front. I don't have a context for this.
What's going on in this painting?
Do, 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 do. And then I can, like, normalize the brightness again.
Okay, I'm shooting from the hip here. This figure embracing the vine appears to be a stranger from another tribe.
Too dark.
He's perhaps a warrior or conqueror. He comes to this domain and probably poses a threat. They're either turning him back or defeating him by bringing the cacao to him. These other characters are preparing the cacao in some way, probably putting it in the form it's used against the stranger.
Okay. Quit-ta-caholic?
What's quite a chocoholic doing with the cacao? Just displaying them, a la Carol Merrill?
No, apparently he's playing a primitive game called Pods, in which you throw the pods onto each other and see if you can get them to flip over.
Okay, quite a chocoholic, huh? Hey, Flodarian. Wonder if the new people, two people in the new apartment, will enjoy the mist car? Alright, we still have it. I think we still have it. Let's see. But then we have... Oh, that's Sasuke. I don't know. Maybe I don't still have... I don't have it in the right folder for this... I don't have it in the right folder for this computer. I had it on my old computer. I don't think we use the mist car anymore. Okay, so... Am I supposed to... Oh, beams. Touch. Try to touch one of the beams, Josie Snickers. Presto. Hello, Presto. Hey, Parabex. What's the deal with corn nuts, cacao?
Alright, so I'm no Michael Jordan.
Jake, my sweet, you are many wonderful things, but when it comes to basketball, you're not even Woody Harrelson.
I thought he tried to reach up and touch the thing. Ancient timbers have no purpose. Oh, there's more stuff over here. Okay. Tripod? Sunken fire pit's probably the source of the unpleasant smoky smell. A cauldron? Remove. You gently lift the cauldron off the hook. Do I put sugarcane in the cauldron? Okay, you don't put that in there. So do I have to make chocolate? Disassemble the tripod?
Jake, that's hundreds of years old.
It's in good shape.
You might not be able to put it together again.
It's simple. Look, three holes. Bada bing, bada bang, bada boom.
It's a national treasure.
I'm not going to hurt it.
It could be worth a tremendous amount of money.
Well, maybe we shouldn't mess with it.
Okay, so maybe you have to make chocolate? If I read these
paintings?
How
do they use the cacao against the stranger?
Well, there are several things being done to them. One of them is cleaning it, one is cooking, one seems to be fanning it.
Cleaning, cooking, fanning. Could be a hint. Oh, do I have more stuff? Oh, I also have a pencil. Wait, chocolate. Oh, it's brochure. Okay. You've never had so many items. I haven't used that before. It's a beer thing. It's a beer thing. That's the exit. There's like a 360 degree movement thing in this game. Okay, so look at the fire pit. Flat depression in the rocks is identical to the one on the other side of the room. It's clean of ashes and has no tripod. I put this over here. Cauldron's unsteady, having been built to hang on the tripod. Yeah, another. Do I do anything in the fire pit? I may have to get more items. I don't know that we fully explored outside. Put the cauldron on the altar. I think we have to fill it with something and then do like this stuff.
Did they poison it? Perhaps. It's possible. The Guarani were heavily into growing manioc, which is a natural source of cyanide. But I don't think they would have done that. They worshipped cacao and probably wouldn't have done anything that might have been considered tainting it. They mostly drank it. I don't know if they figured out sweetening. It might have been very bitter. Wouldn't be to today's palate at all.
I always called it cacao. Cacao, but I don't know if that's right. Let's go back outside and search around. I think we have to get some beans. I think we have to get some chocolate beans. Top floor. Hieroglyphics. A tree. Tree? Lift it?
Stand back, Lois. I'll just lift this tree right out of the way.
Oh, Clark, a rough, tough cream puff like you. Who do you think you are, Superman?
Do I drink cacao? Cacao? I do not drink cacao. So can
maybe
we...
Maybe we can roll the tree out of the way.
We stuck in here?
Right, sure.
We stuck in here? She rolls her eyes and joins you by the tree, where you put your shoulders to the tree. The tree moves, but nearly imperceptibly. Are we stuck here? Large fallen tree blocks your way. Is that how the tree fell in the way? So that would help us. That would help us to know that everything we have to do is in here. It looks like the tree blocked our way, right? No, we go out here. Never mind. We can't go that way. Okay, so I wonder if there's some cacao out here. Leaning statue.
Have you figured out who this big-time head was?
Not yet. I suspect he was a lesser god, probably a guardian or protector for quite a chocoholic.
Check the grounds. I think there's something down here, because we didn't really explore down here. Cacao. Cacao? I would call it cacao. I don't know how it's pronounced. Let's look it up. I think we looked it up last time.
Cacao.
Cacao.
Cacao. Cacao. Cacao. Cacao. Cacao.
Cacao. Cacao. Cacao. Cacao. Daylight gone, man. Me wanna go. Cacao. Check out the ground. Dig. You dig at the ground to uncover an expanse of some smooth metallic substance covered with alien markings.
Right. Another flying saucer.
Maybe if we ignore it, it'll go away.
Yeah.
You cover up the saucer and drop the dirt down around it. Okay. It's hard to figure out, wait, rocks? Should we take this? You would, there's that trick elbow of yours. Push the rocks. All the useful adventure-type objects have been completely crushed by the last adventure game production company that came through here. Okay, so that means I don't have to... I feel like I have to get some cacao beans. You eat cacao every day with cashews? What is cacao, Andrew? What do you mean? When you say you eat cacao, you eat the beans? You eat, like, dried beans? Hey, Zerodyne. Kikia? Hambone? I can go with that. Parachute pack. Can we reel it in? You climb up the host tree and snag one of the parachute cords. You tug on it many times, showering leaves, branches, spiders, insects, lizards, and other small animals onto Josie. Eventually, you're able to bring the pack all the way over to the tree. You shimmy back down the tree and admire your handiwork. What did we got it? We picked it up? What did we do? Did we get that? Why is this so slow? Oh, you can hold it in. That's pretty funny. Take the walkie-talkie. Okay, we got a walkie-talkie. Out of there. You reeled in Guzman's abandoned parachute, so now we have a walkie-talkie. Tune it? I don't know how to tune it. This must be how we escape, or... A-O... I don't really know what we need to put here yet, but we have A, B, C, D, E, F, and up to... And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hey, okay. Hey, Mr. Puzzle Man, puzzle my banana. Daylight come, man. I mean, I could try every single... Underneath a zillion layers of static, you hear the happy brass of Al Herpert, not to be confused with Bert Al Herp. Somebody gets that in chat, I'm sure. B.O. Stinky, you set the dials and press the side button.
Hello, hello?
You wait a while.
Hello?
You wait a while longer, a man picks up sounding out of breath. He says something, then follows it up with some request for confirmation. Before you can respond, the breathless man says something ended with gracias, and the frequency goes dead. Is there a different thing on all? This game has so much writing. Okay. Maybe it's random every time. Make me a ranker enough to be mad. This game has a ton of, like, just needless writing. The most that I've ever seen in a game.
Oh, there, damn call. I said, how good could the hotel possibly be? Do you know what the idea of brunch is in Brazil?
I've never seen it before. It's cacao nibs. They're dried pieces of raw chocolate. Okay, I've never had that, actually. I don't even know what it's like. Is it, like, hard to chew through? Is it hard to chew through, or is it soft? A cacao nib? What's cacao nib look like? Cacao nib. Oh, I see. It's like little pieces of chocolate. Raw... nibs? Looks like rocks. You eat rocks? Is it chocolate? I thought cacao came from like a bean. They're crunchy. So this is like the piece of the plant? This is a piece of the plant? Legend made Unreal 2. Legend Entertainment. Or, hey, Grunt Guru, hello. They're good in yogurt, unsweetened chocolate. Okay, so we got a walkie chalkie. What am I looking for here?
All this blur.
Okay, I can't. We can't read everything. We just can't. It'll kill us. It'll kill us. So we have to try to. I just have to try to look through this without reading every single thing. No tree, forest floor. Look at the fern.
All this.
I hope.
No. Said it's. He says it makes him miss his local Bennigan's. They still have Bennigan's in Hawaii, I think. Granddaddy of trees sits on a small rise 30 feet away. You believe it to be wizened. You're not sure because though you've seen the word wizened, you're not sure what it means or whether it's pronounced with a long I or a short I. Wizened or wizened? Climb the wizened tree. It has several large holes that might have animals right in them. Josie will protect you. The sky. Forest floor. Dig. Scrape at the ground with your foot. Grubs and worms. The thicket. Gnaw the thicket. Oh, we already got some of the, we already got the sugar cane. I think we have to make sugary chocolate. But I don't know how to get the beans. We need some of Andrew's cacao nibs. You willing to share? The cacao's the bean, the chocolate is the beans dried, made into powder. So those, this comes from the bean? It looks like pieces of chocolate, though. This cacao nib, it hasn't gone through the chocolate process yet. Okay, so it's like stuff that fell on the floor. Hey, Toasty.
Okay. You're glowing.
Haven't done this in years.
He was climbing the excellent tree.
You're glowing.
Toasty, how are you? How are you feeling today? How was the toaster today? How'd the inside of the toaster feel today? Toasty, was it warm? Crunchy? Are you crunchy? Are you burnt today? Feeling a little burnt. Dun, 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 dun. Nice and toasty. Makes sense. Okay. We can go up here and look up. Okay, maybe we just do go in here. We can try going back to the first area as well if we need to. How about these vines? Take them. Nothing capable of cutting a vine. Forget about it. Forget about cutting that vine. I wonder if we need something that can cut a vine. Do we need to read the hieroglyphics?
Do you know what these...
I should be able to get this. I don't know. The curlicue is subtly different from the one they used in the other room, so I think it represents a form of... a variation of the cacao they worshipped here.
What about him?
The face is...
I think they're saying
that salvation, whether that means an afterlife or the continuation
bring
of...
Bring together a stranger and cacao. So we need... Do we need the cacao? We already read that before. We need to make cacao. We need to do the cacao. We need to find some cacao. Cacao. We need to make some cacao. It tastes like chocolate, but 100% flavor. Too intense for most people. But not for wild. Not for the wild people. The wild Hawaiians. Who, you know, live hard lives on the sea. Yeah. But not like weak people like me, yeah. Weak society dwellers like me can't handle the cacao nibs, but you've been snacking on raw cacao nibs since you were exited the womb. Andrew has. Yeah, makes sense. Check out the tiled floor. It's uneven and difficult to walk on.
It ain't no Sphinx.
Oh yeah, talk about the Sphinx. All right, let's go inside. Need sugar? Well, not if you're a rough man of the earth. You don't need no sugar. Cacao nibs are cacao beans cut up into chunks. Like Chunk from Goonies. Dum bum dum bum bum dum bum bam 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 bum ba ding bong ba dong ding dong.
I think it's remarkable how the stones, so apparently randomly shaped, can fit together so nicely.
You never eat floor chocolate.
They break them.
Dude, I eat anything, whether it's on the floor, ceiling, walls. I eat it all, man. And you don't waste food. Should we use the matches in the fire pit? Restrain. Put the matches in the fire pit. No. Look at the fire pit. Another fire pit. I mean, I don't put this over here. You put it in the other fire pit. I've got to put something in there, man. In the US, do you refer to the fringes of society as the bangs of society? No, we don't. Good question. Thank you for the question. No, we don't. Da, 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 da. Yes, like Chunk from the Goonies. Oh, okay. Wait, was Chunk a cacao nib cut up? Oh, wow, it's horrible. Da, 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 da. You pour it into your coffee with no sugar. Puke Masters are rough men of the earth. Oh, like a Retro Island Andrew. Retro Sland Gaming. Grove entrance. Do we have to get through there? Maybe we have to figure out how to get through here. What if we burn this? What if we use the wrench on the tree? What if we have to... What would be better if some sort of pegboard with a hook and tape outline of the wrench? Okay. Making jokies. Making some jokies. I think we need to nutcrack the beans too, maybe. You've needed a nutcracker for years. Bellows. It was all bellows. Here's the cauldron. I wonder if we need to... Okay, does this help me if we read this? This is the chocolate brochure. Maybe this shows me... Oh, didn't. Navel jelly? Put the navel jelly on the tree? Make it... It's only for Rusty. I just have a friend named Rusty. You don't like dark chocolate? Is this a puzzle game? It's an adventure game. It's pretty standard point and click, but it also has puzzles. But very few. It's mostly like... point and click, but from a first-person perspective. Lift the marble slabs, pull on the bottom slab, then the top bottom slab, and neither has any give. Oh, man. Need to give. There needs to be a give and take, you know? Alright, do we need to search through this foliage?
Hey,
climb the tree?
Hey.
Search the foliage, you thrash
you
among
do?
The plant
Looking
life.
Looking for a fungi.
You and me both.
Ah, pick it. It's hard to pick. Eat. You had ornamental food just last night. Why don't you eat the bugs in your old apartment? I don't live there anymore. Those are not. I don't own those anymore. I don't own those anymore. This foliage. We gotta find some cacao, right, man? Okay, let's try going back to. See if I can figure out how to get back to. Back to where we started. I can figure it out. Explore the temple ruins. Josie calls you back.
Hey, stick with the tour group.
But
it's not on the itinerary. If you don't like it, complain to your travel agent.
Hey, coffee
That'd
cup.
Be you.
Sorry.
Hey, coffee cup,
see
arcade.
Me during office hours.
Hey, coffee cup. Cacao's Chunk from the Goonies. I get it now. Yeah. Indiana Jones. Is it dark and hard to see? I don't know. Does anybody else think it's dark? You mean the game? Is the game dark? I'll brighten it. Brighten it for you. Mist. Gorilla's in there. Play in the mist. You bought the wrong game. Play mist. Bought the wrong game. If it's dark, let me know. The puzzle earlier, that was on hard. You can also choose easy. You can choose easy and medium. I chose hard because, you know, I've done a lot of Picross in my life. And I need a challenge, or else I decay away into nothing. Okay. No, okay. I'm trying to get back to where we were before. Like, maybe there's some chocolate there. We can melt away. Or do I need to find the correct... This is another vine mess you got me into. Does anything look like chocolate here? This? The host tree? Climb the tree and find an old brass key. Josie finds a keyhole in the tree, opens it, and the gnome walks out. The gnome had been looking for that key for a long time, so he gives you a locket. And you take it to the town and trade it for a gold tie tack, which you later use to stab the sorcerer and save the princess. There, satisfied? Okay, thank you, I am satisfied. It could be that I have to use the walkie-talkie, but I don't think so. I think we have to make chocolate. Can we talk to this monkey? Give the monkey something. Oh, what's up with this map? Oh, this is a map of the surrounding area. This has all the radio codes. Okay, I think I want to try to get back to that first area we were in. But I don't know exactly where it is. The shaggy tree? Shaggy! The hairy bark's easy to grip, but the large plumes of leaves are impossible to get past. Look at it. Something special. Search the roots. You root around among the roots, pawing and snuffling and freaking Josie out big
what
time.
What in the world?
Ralph taught me this. Took me down to Central Park. We sniffed out about $500 worth of truffles. You want to try?
Maybe later.
Yeah, I was renting those. I was renting those bugs.
When are you in the game? Okay. No, if it's dark, let me know. Don't apologize. If it's dark and I don't notice. Every streamer always wants to know if you can't see, like if it looks bad. Because we can't always see what you guys see. It's not a problem. Stand in tree, climb the tree, look at, this just takes me back where I was. Maybe we can't get back to where we were before. There was another area. Try this. There was another area. Okay, there's here and here. Okay. Here? There it is. Okay, I have a receding airline. This area. Like, maybe it... Oh, that guy's awake again. Okay, what if I, the map... Okay, try B2. I wonder if we have to get rid of them, and then we can explore this area some more. Let's try B2. Bum, bop, beep, boop, beep, bop, beep, boop, beep, bop. There's a little static on this line. A harsh voice answers your squawk, and you recognize it as Alana's.
We'd like to speak to you regarding the trees and the grove.
Who you name? I know who you are.
Well, then why are you asking?
Come back to the plane. You are in big trouble.
Why would we want to come back to the plane if you're just going to be angry at us?
What'd you do that for?
Thought I'd give him time to work on his act. The sincerity just wasn't there.
Ugh. Yeah, Picross 3D's great. I don't think I ever got the second one, though, Master Gregor, but I did like 3D Picross. Yeah. Picross 3D. Or there was one I didn't get. Okay, there's also B0. Hear voices in the background, no one's
Could
picking up the walkie-talkie.
Unionized workers here?
Stranger things have happened.
Dun, dun, dun. Hey, T-Can. Stream looks bad. Okay, thank you for letting me know. I'll try to fix it for next time. Hey, Adamek. Yeah, I am. It's great. It's great. Let's try D4. Let's go from ABC. Let's go A8. Let's see what happens if we call all these. A8. He set the dials to A8 and a man answers. He says something that definitely sounds like a question. You're stymied for a response.
Hi, I want you to take a break.
The man doesn't respond for several seconds. When he does, it's another short question. This one's sounding a little peeved.
Yes. C.
The voice answers and trails off in a string of mutters, which you correctly assume to be curses. Okay. Do I need to have him take a break here? Okay, A8. We had somebody take a break at A8. Let me look at the map over there. How about C1? C1. Where do you try B0 and B2? Try C1. The man shouts something at you. You can hardly hear him through the roar of machinery.
Turn off your bulldozer! Go home! We have all the pencils we need!
The man shouts something back, but it doesn't sound like English. Frustrated, you stop trying to talk to him. We're stopping a pencil company from deforesting, so that's why he said pencils. C8. Now C8. This must do something. Is this the both of you? Dun. They also know we're here. You can hear a voice somewhere under a thick blanket of static and background noise. Ghostly baby doll female. Come into the light, Carol Ann. I don't get that. Bam. Let's see, C1, C8, D4, D4. If you don't get the reference, you'll just be confused in this game. In response to your squawk, a man answers and barks a question at you.
Are you asking nicely? I can't tell.
All right, Gregor, Master Gregor, see you later. Have a good day. I'm just joshing. Oh, okay, nice. I thought you weren't joshing. Have a good day. Lem. Yeah. Lem. D4, F9. 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 No offense, but F9. You squawk and a man replies who sounds drunk. His words are slurred.
Hey, I want some of whatever you're having.
The man responds surprisingly in English and in extremely impolite polite language. Then he hiccups and cuts himself off in mid-hick. He's drunk? You call him again? You re-squawk the drunk man. He replies his words even more jumbled, weaving Portuguese and English. Then you hear something that sounds like a bottle dropping and the man stops answering. Is that him? Is this be him? So there's a drunk guy at F9? Man, there's no response from a man who's either drunk or high. Okay, I'm not exactly sure what this does. Maybe this is how you escape? We called all the things. This is the runway, B2. This is where we are right now. This is where we are right now. I wonder if we have to go to BO. A different... Or we have to get back in the plane and take it off, or... Not really sure. I don't know why... What the deal with that is. Well, you don't want to talk to him. You can die, but... You can die in this, but you just restart right away, so... There's no, like... There's no actual deaths in this. I don't think there's dead ends either. I can't remember. Poltergeist? Okay, I haven't seen Poltergeist. When a salesperson comes to your door, I'm going to turn off the bulldozers. We got all the pencils we need. You should do that. Any chocolate in here? This part's kind of difficult because there's so many different... It seems like the hardest part of the game so far to figure out. Who's joshing? Flan. Apparently his name's Josh. Can we open any of these crates?
Josie, can you open this crate?
What makes you think I can open it?
Well, you've got longer fingernails.
It's going to take more than long fingernails to open this.
Bop. Bop, 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 bop. Boop. Beep, bop, boop, bim, boom.
Wow.
We already tried opening all this stuff previously. Do we have a crowbar? Maybe we need a crowbar to open this crate, this wrench? The pipe wrench with the crate. I might need to look it up. There's just a lot of stuff to look at. I'm not exactly... There's so many... we're in a forest. We're in a thick forest. I don't know if I need to find a bean somewhere. Make sure I look at every single plant, you know? It's very pixel hunty and confusing. This way? Go back this way. Leaning statue. Climb it. You don't need to go to the head right now.
Hey, statue.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what they want from me. We already looked in there. Read the urn?
I'm not sure what it is this civil...
That's their smoking thing. Search it. Sand. Guess we'll go up here. Anything else here? Can we take any beans out here? I think we need to get beans or chocolate somehow. Do we mix, go? Can we put anything else in the pot? We have these bellows. Look at the bellows. This was probably a bellows at one time meant to stoke the fire. Though the wood is still in fine shape, the animal hide has fallen into disrepair with several large holes and tattered edges. So we have to fix this. We also have to fix this with gauze. You pull out great quantities of the bandage tape, sever them on the pointed end, and wrap the tape around the bellows, sealing up all the holes in the old hide.
Is that going to be airtight?
Spare me. I'm doing okay.
Now that's pride in craftsmanship.
Okay, so we fixed the bellows. Well, we did something. We're doing something. Let's go back in. Maybe we just need to remove the cauldron to, light the fire pit. Like, light the fire pit with matches. It keeps saying put. Oh, strike the matches. Maybe you should wait and see if you can put them to good use. Light, like, the map, or... Light any of this stuff that we have? Light the... What's in my wallet again? And my wallet is... Picture of my wife and child and my driver's license. I'm going to close that. Let's take a closer look at the cauldron. The worship cauldron. Empty it? There's nothing to empty. Can we put the sugar cane in there? Can we put the cauldron back? It's unsteady, having been built to hang on a tripod. You have to put it on the tripod. I think we have to put stuff in it. Put the sugar cane in the cauldron? Yeah. I have to get something else and then put the sugar in it, too. I don't know how to find what I need. If we look at the sugar cane, it's delicious and sweet sugar cane. Maybe we need a crowbar, maybe, to open the thing. Yeah, you combine objects in this game, yeah. Matches. It just says put. It doesn't actually say... When you say strike, it doesn't say strike it on something else. Maybe I need wood? Do I need wood? Do I have wood? Do I need wood? A bamboo pole? That doesn't count as wood. Nutcracker. Do we need to crack some nuts? This part is kind of dark, yeah. Actually, this part is dark. Do-ba-ba-do. What time is it? Hey, tactical precision. Hey, tactical precision. Hello. Yeah. Go. Nutcracker or wrench. Can we look at this? The pipe wrench from the toolbox. The nutcracker. No, we're not going to do any jokes about the word nutcracker. Thank you. I appreciate that. Bellows on the fire pit. Keep the bellows with you. Burn this pencil. Burn this pencil. I mean, we have matches. It just says put. It doesn't say, like, use them. Ashes? Oh, there's ashes. Take the ashes. It keeps slipping through your fingers. Search the ashes. They're nothing but charred lumps of wood. Maybe we need to get some wood. Also, wood and something with the altar. Lie on it. Look at it.
Who's this guy? If it is a guy.
Nutcracker. Keep reading these. She explains how the invader is repelled, defeated, or won over by the cacao. The parallels to your own situation are hard to miss. We need to make the cacao. We need to make cacao. But there is no cacao. There must be some cacao somewhere. How about this fire pit? Looks identical. Do we move the tripod? Like, disassemble it?
Jake!
She tells us not to take it apart. She tells us not to take it apart. Look at it. Smooth, heavy wooden legs connected through carefully drilled holes in the skull.
They're really into chocolate, which makes me think they must have been pretty damn civilized. But they're also into this skull motif.
Well, this smacks of Guarani. Actually, this far north, they were the Tupinamba. Cannibals.
Cannibals? Oh, man. Dun. I put it down because the lighting is messed up. Until I fix the lighting, I'm not going to use my green screen. You don't really need it for 4-3 games anyway, which I mostly play. Gong. Alright, we might need a hint. Because I think I have to find something in the wilderness. Maybe this tree.
Stand back, Lois.
Oh.
The matches on the tree. Nutcrack the tree. I don't really understand the radio thing either. I don't really understand what's going on with that. Something with the drunk guy, but there's no other ways to go to where those other locations are that we radioed. These vines. Nothing capable of cutting a vine. Let me get a hint. Let's get a hint. Okay, Josie. Through the office. You go through the plane part. Put the eye stones in Chocoholic. Take the cauldron. Note the tree. You need something to move it. Yeah. Tune the walkie-talkie to C5 to call the Jeep. Okay. Let's use that as our hint. And we go this way. We did need to do something with the walkie-talkie. C5? Oh, because C5's on the back of the Jeep. Oh. Okay. It's been 2 weeks, so... When was the last time we played this? Not 2 weeks. It's been a week and a half or something. Okay. So we tune this to C5. Alright, my bad. C5. The man who answers your squawk is chewing something as he speaks. You can't understand him. He's eating the cacao. He's got the cacao.
This is Alaniz. Get over here. I think there's something wrong with this whiskey.
They're shocked to hear the man say, okay. We left. Oh, what's in the Jeep? Search the Jeep. You extract one tire iron and one Jeep jack. From the Jeep.
Are you a Jeep or a sport utility vehicle?
Great Caesar's ghost. I'm a sport utility vehicle. And don't call me Jeep.
What's that from? Drive the Jeep. There are no keys. You never be able to get it hotwired without that worker hearing you. They're looking here together. They're talking about the whiskey. Wow, you cunningly managed to get the old army vehicle parked right where you can get to it. Talk about Jeep thrills. Hey, Toasty, how's the inside of the toaster? kick piano handbone. What's up, burrito? The C5 on the Jeep, we had read it before, but it's been... We'd played this last Sunday. Not the previous Sunday, but the one before that. I just kind of, like, forgot. Because I moved. All right, so now we have a tire iron.
How are you supposed to iron a tire with this?
And a Jeep jack. So use the Jeep jack to move the tree. Jeep thrills. Bap. It's Toasty. Nice. Nice, Toasty. That's cool. Super cool. Okay, Jeep jack on the tree, baby. You wedge the jack under the tree, alright? And then use the tire iron on the Jeep jack. You slip the flat end of the tire iron into the slot and bear down. At first, it seems like the jack will give way. The tire iron looks like it's bending. Within a few strokes, the gnarled tree begins to rise. Dirt and leaves patter to the stone floor. The jack's hold on the tree seems tentative at best. You stop pumping just before the jack reaches the height limit, giving you just enough berth to slip underneath. Josie looks with trepidation at the tree. You plant a foot on it and lean your weight onto it, figuring that if the tree stays up, fine. If the tree falls over, it will roll back enough to permit you to squeeze out at the top. But the jack is bitten into the wood and seems solidly in place. What? Take the branches? You gather all the branches you can find. There's the wood we need, baby. There's the wood we need. Bum, ba-dum, bum. Branches in the fire pit. Note, the following conversation has had all its sparkling wit and flippant commentary removed and replaced with artless exposition and overly obvious hints so that you can see what you'd be getting with a cheaper, lower quality computer adventure game.
Oh, great. You dropped those branches right in the fire pit. Now you've got ashes all over them. They'll be useless. What shall we do with them?
I'm sorry. Maybe we should just burn them and forget about them.
What, you mean create a fire here in the fire pit? Can we do that?
Yes, I think we can.
Oh, Jake, I'm so glad you're here to do the thinking for us.
Hey, I am the hero. It is what I do.
That is very funny. This is by Josh Mandel, by the way, who worked at Sierra. Worked on, I guess, the main game he designed at Sierra. The major thing he helped design at Sierra was Freddy Farkas with Al Lowe, as far as I know. There's this is like the ultimate punny and make fun of adventure gamey adventure game that's out there, that exists, that I've ever seen or played. Light the matches. I mean, light the fire. We can use the bellows. I assume it's just going to stay there and not burn out. If it does, we'll be okay. You can't dead end in this. You're aroused. Excellent. Da, 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 da. All right. Excellent. I want everybody to be feeling good. Okay. Past tree. Oh, cacao tree, baby. What have we got here? Cacao pods, baby. You take some of the cacao pods. Da, da, da. You and Josie crush the husk with your feet until you have a sizable pile of beans. That's what Andrew does. Taste the cacao pods. You lick one of the pods. It tastes nothing and feels like licking an onion skin. Smell it. The pods are slightly fragrant, but the fragrance bears no resemblance to chocolate. Here you guys can see how I'm sitting in a... I'm twisting right now. I'm twisted. Totally twisted. This is retrograde Tom. Totally twisted. This is what Andrew does. He, like, crushes them with his feet and stuff. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. He licks the pod. Alcove. Enter. You start to check the alcoves to see if they lead anywhere. They're choked with leaf insect nests, webs made by either very large or industrious spiders, vines, a variety of animal dens, and the occasional snake. You decide to forego further exploration until and unless you are outfitted with a great deal of protective gear. Cacao tree. A grove path. A grove path. I saw branches somewhere. Boulder?
What's that big round thing?
Boulder.
Okay. Tell me what that big round thing is right now.
See what I mean? No other game does that and has someone voice crap like that. No other game has someone voice crap like that. Maybe Freddy Farkas does. Maybe. Literally thousands. Give us thousands of puns. Toes and chocolate. That's your thing? Oh, yeah. Down, climb the stone wall. You clamber up the stone wall and look out over the top. In one direction, you see more forest from the ancient spruce city. In the other direction, you vaguely make out plumes of diesel exhaust from the heavy equipment in the distance. This area is actually pretty light with puns. Stone well, descend. You make your first mistake by climbing into the well head first instead of feet first, as any sane person would do. Josie holds your ankles until you're down as far as she can reach. You make a mental note and try this again, sometime when you have a rope or something. She pounds the toes of your sneakers into the crumbling mortar so as to give you a couple of toe holds, and she lets go. You start to sweat as you consider your position.
Okay. I'm a man. Let's go. Just like climbing up a steep cliff, only gravity's working with me instead of against me, so it should be easier.
Yeah, doesn't that get sand all over the chocolate? Andrew, hey, Board Game Heaven.
Well, after such a fall as this, I shall think nothing of tumbling downstairs. How brave they'll all think me at home.
The next thing you remember is Josie giving you mouth-to-mouth, which might have been memorable if you didn't have a gullet full of well water.
I want you to sit down for a while and just think about what you did.
Like, what other game would put that kind of... It would be like, oh, it's a well. This game has him going headfirst into the well, her, like, trying to help you climb into the well, you fall into the well, wake up, get mouth-to-mouth. This game's insane. This game's completely insane. It's great, though. The branches aren't within reach. All right, we got the cacao. I was just trying to explore it a little bit. Like, most games would not even put... It's just supposed to be funny all over. It's really unique. The delivery is done yet. It always has the same vibe to it, too, the whole time. It's pretty good. Cacao beans in the cauldron. Sugar cane in the cauldron. Too early. Okay, now we make the chocolate. Make the chocolate. I didn't know the game was this good either, especially like at the beginning. It's just so different. So it's sometimes some games are just so different than others. It's hard to understand what it's doing. It has like a different vibe than any other game. Hard to understand what it's doing at first. Once you understand this game, yeah. I mean, once I started to understand it anyway, I started to like it a lot more. I put the cauldron on the fire. Put the cauldron on the tripod. Do I burn these things? Or do I have to put water in there? Put the cauldron in the tripod.
Are you trying to make dirty cacao bean soup?
I shouldn't be.
Then why are you?
Maybe I should just stop then.
Oh, okay. Hold on. Empty it. Cacao beans. Wait, Andrew knows how a yuckier, more mucilaginous pile of beans you've yet to see. Andrew knows how to do this. Oh, nut crack them. Nut crack the beans. Using the nutcracker knows you no good. The tire iron the beans. Okay, how do you process cacao beans? Cacao. Beans don't burn. Yeah, I've got to, Do I need to get water? Not morphine. You know, whether you like the humor or not, there was a lot of effort and creativity put into this game. And it's very well done. Yeah, the Xanth game is nothing compared to this. Xanth game I remember being like, oh, it's silly. A little bit dumb. It's not as high quality. This has a ton of production values. Whoa, I'm falling. I'm fine. Carpet nut bomb the jungle like we did to the banana. Alright, I have to figure out what to do with these beans. What do I do with these beans? Smash them? What do I do with the beans? Burn them? What do I do with the beans? Put them in like the fire pit? Put them on the altar? It's nasty beans. Maybe I need to get beans that are not gross. Hey, Danny boy. It also has a cool structure, yeah, like the five different quests you can do in any order that all have their own environment and characters and theme. Alright, climb the cacao tree. Alright, how about these pods? Taste them. Smell them. Look at
them. Are these cacao pods?
They are indeed. They're very unusual, though. The husks are a little smaller and paler.
She takes a pod, puts it on the ground, crushes it with her foot, exposing a few large mucilaginous beans.
The husk is a lot more fragile, and the beans are larger, but there's fewer of them per pod. This is not Hershey's, if you get my drift.
The Hershey Highway. Right, everyone? You know what I mean? This is not the Hershey Highway. Hey, Prune. Do beans need to be washed? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe. There was something like branches somewhere? Oh, more. Do I need more branches? Haven't begun to use the ones you've already taken. Jelly? Jelly in the cauldron? Jelly in the cauldron? Do I need to get water? Oh, well. The well. The cauldron in the well. Nobody get the cauldron if you put it in the well now. I think we need to get a vine and lower it into the well. But we don't have anything sharp. Alright, so maybe use the tire iron. Can we take a vine? Maybe use the tire iron as like a crowbar for the crates and the plane. We need to get a vine. There's vines here. Let's go back in the plane, see if we can use the tire iron in the crates. Oh, it did work. Okay. We're able to pry off the side of the crate. Satellite dish? Why, it takes more time and money to set up and maintain these than it would cost to build your own TV studio and produce your own programming. Packing material? You consider taking a handful of packing peanuts as a snack, but then you realize there are all sorts of nuts and berries to be found outside. Okay. Use the... With several pulls of the tire iron, the top of the crate comes off, enough for you to pull it open the rest of the way. Oh, an airplane? Oh, no, that's the actual airplane. Can we... Is it open? It doesn't look open to me. Look in the crate. Among the styrofoam peanuts, I found a complicated remote control and various pieces of mounting hardware. So I guess we don't want that one. Third crate. Open this one with it. You're revealing the underside of a small refrigerator. Okay, how about this one? You jam the flat end in, you discover this crate's full of electronic gear. A coax cable? Okay, maybe we lower it with the coax cable. Coax on the cauldron. Looping the cable through the cauldron's massive handles, you tie several...
Those are all slip knots.
Trust me.
You yank on the cable to prove the strength of your knots. On your third and hardest yank, the cauldron slips out of the knots and clatters to the floor, making a horrendous racket that hurts your ears. Josie grabs the cable from you and deftly weaves a pattern of small, tight knots that hogties the cauldron perfectly and hands it back to you.
Oh, yeah, well, if I wanted to show off.
Like, it makes everything silly, even just tying a knot onto a, onto the cauldron. Makes everything silly. Hey, Osmosis. We're fine. Am I back in the plane? So we need to get water. Now we lower the cauldron down there. Get some water. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. We're lowering it down. There's also animations, too. It's not just static screens all the time, which is cool. This is a Legend has really great aesthetics in all of their games. I don't exactly remember Xanth, but I know even like Shannara was probably my least favorite one. But even that one has really great graphics. You lower the pot into the stone well. When you pull it back, you find a cauldron full of
wood. All right, we scored water. Jake, look.
Reach for the sky. Reach for the sky, I say to you. I am warning you.
Usman.
Reach, or you will have your own blood on your hands. Do not try my patience. Do not try my patience for a longer time. All right, don't reach for the sky. Very good.
Reach for which guy? You reach for the sky, Guzman grins at you cockily.
So, we meet again. Turn around. Take the map out of his pants and toss it to me.
He caught us. This is the guy whose plane
Time cop.
And the walkie-talkie.
The weight of the walkie-talkie is lifted from your hip. This is the guy whose plane...
Every hero becomes a bore. Ralph Waldo Emerson.
Turn around again slowly.
Yeah? Well, up yours too, buddy. David Mamet.
Stop suppressing a laugh. You are in big, hot, troubled, bottled water. I am going to get the authorities. Mr. Kiskolon, he is going to be very upset. Very upset.
Fine. You go tell Mr. Kiskolon that we are very upset with him. We are very angry at him. So you go get him right now and bring him here right away. And bring the authorities with you.
Okay. Don't go away. I'll be back as soon as I can.
No, the stream will end at 3:15 my time ish. 3:15. So in an hour 15 minutes.
It's okay. I didn't hurt myself.
Finally, he squeezes under the tree and it's gone. You and Josie look at each other, but you're not sure what to say. You both shrug. Sorry, I kind of missed that. I missed what happened. What did it say? I missed like one of the paragraphs. He's gone now? But he took some of our stuff? Alright, beans in the... I missed what happened completely. He caught us, and then what happened that made him leave? Water. So that was the guy whose plane we took here, but then he found out we weren't who we said we were. And then we made him fall out of the plane. We as the plane was flying in air, and he had to use a parachute. He takes a few steps back, trips, dusts himself off, and keeps backing up. Oh, okay. God. Stop suppressing a laugh. Yo, Pern, thanks for the gift subs. Thank you so much, Pern. Appreciate that. Okay, now can I put the cauldron on here? Or do we put the sugar cane in there now? No, okay. The cauldron, put this on the tripod.
We want to roast the beans, not boil them.
What?
We should dump out the water first.
Oh, well, we wash them.
Why don't you do this?
You're the natural born leader around here.
That I am not.
Oh, yes, you are.
So we need to wash the beans because they're nasty. Oh man, I bet Andrew knew that. And he's like laughing. Like, of course you gotta wash the beans, you idiot. Empty the cauldron. There, now the beans are nice and clean. And now we can put it under the tripod. You hang the cauldron back on the tripod over the grape pit. Pour one out for Grapey. Oh, grape soda, got one. Pour one out for Grapey. Grape soda drinks his own blood. You hang the cauldron back on the tripod over the fire pit. The beans begin to exude an aroma. You and Josie take turns stirring them with the bamboo pole to ensure that they roast evenly. When the beans appear to be properly colored, no small feat in a room with so little light, you remove them from the fire and let them cool for a while. Cool for a while. Okay, now put the roasted beans in the cauldron and the sugar cane in the... Now do you want to... Now how do you make it into chocolate? Chocolate. Smash them with the wrench? Now put them back here? Roast them again? You hang the cauldron back over the fire pit and put the sugar in there? I don't know what to do now. Stoke, make them real hot. Make it real hot. Take the cauldron back. Remove the cauldron. Pot's too hot to remove with your bare hands. Uh-oh. Did I screw up? I don't think you can screw up. Look at the cauldron. A frightening iron pot. I got the roasted beans and then I put it back again. That doesn't seem like a great idea. The cacao steps are bringing back the memories. It's funny how that happens with games, right? Certain's the thing that brings memories back. I don't know how to put out that fire. The jelly on the... Extinguished with... This fire can never be extinguished. It will live on as long as there's hope in the hearts of men. Bellows the... Remove. It's too hot to remove. Uh-oh. What have I done? Pern, thank you for the 100. Thanks, Pern. Thank you very much. Thank you mucho, mucho much. Morphine in the cauldron. Nutcracker. Oh, what did I do? What have I done? Help me.
Out with it, Jake. Just say what's on your mind.
Help me.
What more do we need to do with the cacao?
Check the pamphlet.
Oh, okay.
Will do.
Oh, the pamphlet tells me how to make it. We haven't read that for over a week. All right, let's see. We buy our beans from Brazil. Process our beans. Scraped, washed, roasted. Each bean is cracked to reveal its nib. The nibs are ground between steel rollers. So we need to get the nibs out, but I put it back on the... I put the cauldron back on the hot pot. The chocolate's then sweetened, stirred while being heated, and cooled by a blast of fresh air. Sweetened and conked. Okay, so... then it's of perfect eating quality. Okay, sweetened and conked. Well, we do have this. Do we use this on the cauldron then? How do I get it? Could this be like some kind of a weird dead end, possibly? Or I can't get the call. I need to get that crap back. You don't sweeten it. Too early to put the sugar in. Oh, tripod disassembled to get it.
Jake,
off.
I'm
not.
It could be worth.
Well, I might reload. Let's go back to water cauldron. Down. Water's in the cauldron. You are in the pot as well. What? Did we get the water in the cauldron? Okay. Let's go back and let me just go from here. I don't know if I messed up or if I just couldn't figure out what to do. Probably the latter, but let's just do it this way anyway. Alright, beans are in there. Empty it. Roast the beans. Okay. And then we get the beans out. Okay, look at the beans. They're clean. They're roasted to peak perfection. Okay, and then the thing said to... now, can I sweeten them? The roasted beans don't require sweetening. Put them in here. What did that say again exactly? Hey, Malio. Nasty, nasty mucilaginous beans. Yeah. Mucilaginous. You gotta crack them. We have to crack them. And then grind. Crack and grind. I don't see another wrong. With a little crack and grind. Crack and grind and nibs. Yeah, it's a cool game, Pern. It's a cool game. Very cool game. Put the pipe wrench in the cauldron or empty the cauldron. Smash them with the wrench. Smash them with a nutcracker. Crack them. Using the nutcracker, you extract the chocolate nibs from the roasted beans. I wonder if that's like... something they didn't plan on someone doing, putting them back here. Okay, we extracted the nibs now. Alright, now we got the nibs. And now we have to grind them. In the, now we gotta grind them. I don't see nothing around. Smash them with the wrench? See, have we seen anything that could grind them? Or can we just sweeten them without grinding them? Put them in here. Okay, empty it. Okay, we gotta somehow grind them, according to the brochure. Or what have you seen that could grind something? We cracked them, and then the nibs have to be ground within big steel rollers. And then sweeten it. So, and then heat it, and then cool it with a blast of fresh air. So we gotta grind the chocolate. Never got over the font. I never really noticed that. I think it works out, right? Okay. See, we take this jack back. If we're gonna allow you to try this dangerous stunt, it would have resulted in the loss of 3/5 of your fingers. But Josie's in charge, and she said no. Oh, we were going to, but Josie's in charge, she said no. We're learning how chocolate's made. It's wonderful. See, where do we grind? Where could we potentially grind and bump? Where could we bump and grind? Have this monkey grind. Hey, come halfway around the world for these beans. Keep them. We grind. Somehow grind here. Oh, this game does have like it has an it's having an interface bug right now. That won't let me go here. Let me go here. I forgot it did have a couple bugs last time we played, so we had to restart from an earlier save. Yeah, it doesn't let me go this way. Maybe you just don't need to go back that way? And now I'm worried it's broken. Yeah, I forgot this game did break a couple times. Got nibs. 27. Grind it in the rocks. Try putting the beans on the rocks. Push the rocks.
take rocks. The nibs on the statue? Maybe have to put them on the altar and crush them there. I just didn't try it. The nibs on the altar? Doesn't accomplish anything. Put the nibs in the fire pit? No. Maybe can we grind them in here? Put the nibs in the cauldron? Maybe they're already ground enough. Maybe you don't need to grind them. Maybe you actually don't need to grind them. I just saved it, so let me put the thing back on the tripod.
They're supposed to be smooth at this point, Jake. Don't cook them yet.
Yeah, that must have been a bug that let me put them on them before, on there before. We gotta get them smooth. We gotta get them nibs smooth. So how can we grind them between steel rollers or anything that would let me grind them? I wonder if there's a way to grind them out here. Santa, Rosanna. Something with this stone wall over here? The nibs in the alcove? The nibs on the wall? Yeah, mortar and pestle. How about this alcove? Check the alcoves if they lead anywhere. No, they don't. Not in the well. The sky. Look at the sky. Looking straight up, the sky's bright blue, but looking toward the horizon, the wet swirling mist turns into the sky opaque white.
Egress
light.
Oh, what happened there? So we have to grind, we have to smoothen them out. We gotta grind them, crunch them up. Gotta crunch them up somewhere. Let's see, we might have to load an old save if it's something at the plane. And I can't get back to the plane for whatever reason. Is it something to do with this urn? Urnlet. Okay, don't go back this way. What, the rocks? Like, put them on the ground, the rocks. Where would they get ground up? I would think the Jeep. I think if this is bugged, I have to go back to here. Yeah, we have to go back here. I think it got bugged because if you click in a weird way, the game can kind of bug out sometimes. So let's we clean them. Then we're going to roast them. We roasted them. And then we're going to crack them. And then we're going to see if we can get back to the Jeep area. Or the Jeep plane area. I think it bugged out because I clicked really weird. No, it still doesn't let me go back. Which is weird. I don't know exactly why. If I go back to past tree... I don't have the cable at this point, right? Go back to past tree. I can go back here. And it works, so... What would I smash them on here? I don't know why it doesn't let me go back. I don't know if it's a bug, because this game can bug. Is there anything in here that could grind cacao nibs that we see? These paint cans? Could be these paint cans. They're rolled. They're rollers. Or a mortar and pestle could work. We could try to go from here and see if it's just bugged. Take the coax cable. Use the coax cable to this.
Oh.
We could just see if we bugged it. Go from here. It won't take very long. Cocoa tea is available in South America. Cocoa tea. But not here. Cocoa tea. Interesting. Why is that? All right, lower the cauldron.
All right, Jake.
Reach.
Oh, this guy catches me. So, let me see. We can see what he says because I missed it.
Take the map.
Hey,
the map.
And the walkie-talkie.
Turn out.
Yeah.
Stop suppressing a laugh.
Fine. You go tell Mr. Kiss Colon that we are very upset with him. We are very angry at him.
Okay, don't go away. I'll be back as soon as I can. It's okay. I didn't hurt myself.
Oh, so they just made it a silly situation. Okay. Let me just see if we were bugged or not. Where's the cacao nibs or the beans? Did we not get them on this save? So it was just a silly thing. Cacao pods. Take, put them in here. Empty them out. Or empty the water. Get back in here. Ceremonial cacao. Yeah, I've never quite heard of that here. Fire's burning. Roast them up. Crack them. Okay, now let's see if we can go back to the plane or not. See if we're bugged. I don't think I did anything that would make me bugged at this point. No, you can't go back. That's weird. Okay. Stones, put these on the stones. The bird. The monkey. In, put him in here. Smash him up. Smash him up. Smash him. Smash him up. Did I try the pencil? The pencil. Empty. Smash them outside with the... I don't see anything that would really grind them up here. Alright, Pern, have a good day. Have a good day. Push the rocks. Have a good day. Have a good day. It's not a thermos. Put them on the floor. Put them on the floor. Put them on the altar. I'll just look it up. Let's see. Beans in the cauldron. Step outside the altar room and face an elaborate carving. Put them on the slabs. Okay. I wouldn't have tried that. Put them on the slabs. You arrange the beans on the slabs and then take the stones out and then it crushes them. That's a pretty cool puzzle. That's pretty cool, though it's hard to figure out. That's a cool puzzle. I like that one. I didn't realize you could take those. You know, sometimes you do something in an adventure game, it seems permanent, right? Like, why would I ever want to close the door? Okay, now put the sugar in here. Okay, and then now we want to melt it. Melt the chocolate. And then, yeah, she's blowing it.
Hey, smell that? God, that's incredible. Here, we have to conk them.
A mere bag of shells.
You keep stirring, and I'll use the bellows to cool the surface of the chocolate.
Yes, sir, Mrs. Ghirardelli, sir.
Yeah, his name's Kiss Colin. He's the owner of the Pencil Corporation, and his name is Kiss Colin. After a quarter hour of conking, when the aroma of sweet... we got the chocolate. We got the chocolate. Chocolate in the cauldron. So we did it. So now we put the chocolate on the altar. Or empty it. Pour it into appropriate containers. The medicine kit? Okay, you pour the liquid chocolate into the small box, then working on the bellows, you blow cool air on the liquid chocolate, thus causing a chocolate to set or harden. Alright, we got a chocolate bar. Put that on the altar? Don't leave the chocolate bar lying around, it's too valuable. And don't hold it so tightly, you'll melt it again. This bar of chocolate may be coarsely manufactured, but it's also the mellowest, smoothest, most delectable chocolate you've ever tasted. You're going to try making it last a long time by giving out only very tiny nibbles. Is the point to do something with the chocolate? Or to, just make the chocolate so she can eat it? Give it to her?
That's okay, I've got one of my own.
Okay, she made her own. Da, 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 da. Let's take a quick break. Da, 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 da. We might start using screensavers again. Like the Nightman screensaver. Let's see, let me turn off the After Dark so we can have the Nightman screensaver. Because I know that you guys really love Nightman. A lot of Nightman fans in the chat. Let's see. Okay, here you go. Alright, I'll be right back. Well, let me... Okay, we're not going to use this. We have to do a window capture of... Yeah, the screensavers. Remember these? Nightman. Nightman. There you go. Alright, so check out that Nightman screensaver. I'll be right back. Okay. What do you guys think? You think Nightman should come back? You guys think Nightman should come back, or what do you think? You think it should stay dead? We're gonna try. We're trying to bring Nightman back. We're trying to get it to come back. Okay, now we got a chocolate bar. What's my goal? My goal was to. Maybe I'm not supposed to do anything with any of this. I'm just supposed to get the chocolate. And then give it to Kiss Colin and give it to him and show him how good it is, and then he won't deforest. Maybe that's it. Maybe he's out here. Maybe that's what. Hey, regular orange. There they are. Yeah, maybe this is it. There's Mr. Kiss Colin, Guzman, and some workers here. Yeah, I love After Dark. I still love After Dark. I like Before Dark, too. I also call it day. Before dark, I call it day. All right, give chocolate bar to Kiss Colin. You hand the chocolate bar to Kiss Colin.
Watch this.
It's a chocolate bar, sort of.
Made from the trees in that temple.
This could be poison.
It isn't. I'll eat some if you don't believe me.
Sigmund breaks off a piece of chocolate, gives it to you, smiling nastily. Without hesitation, you pop a piece into your mouth. Sigmund raises an eyebrow. The chocolate's unlike anything you've ever tasted. The crudity of the manufacture has left the texture slightly gritty, but you're virtually unconscious of the flaw. The small, thick chunk of sweet chocolate begins to melt the moment you close your mouth. It dissolves over your tongue. The flavor's intense, with the slightest, the vaguest suggestion of bitterness, yet with a predominant mellowness that suggests dairy, milk, chocolate. He likes it. Kiss Colin, Josie, Guzman, everyone fades into the background. Every nerve fiber in your body receives waves of intoxicated pleasure from the indescribable melange of flavors unfolding within you. Your reaction must have been pretty convincing.
Ooh.
Okay, tasty break. Hello.
Is this chocolate?
That's exactly what it is, and it grows only one place on Earth. And you're about to blow it up and cut it down. Shut up.
It takes a day to make chocolate? Maybe not if it's the best bean in the world. Or it did take a day. Not only does he promise not to cut down the trees, he then vows to cultivate them and sell the pods to the highest bidder. Next thing you know, Josie shakes you.
We can go back now.
We did it. Okay.
We got it. We did it, Jake.
Yeah, okay. Good.
Are you all right?
I'm good. Can we take some of that chocolate back with us?
I'm way ahead of you. Made a bar for each of us while you were in your rapture over there. Thank you, Jake.
Oh, my pleasure.
All right, we finished it. Josie touches the band on her wrist and the world fades to white. She's a time cop. She's a time police. So we went back in time to save the chocolate. We saved the best chocolate. What follows is a rather gushy scene in which Josie extols your virtues to the high heavens. We'll spare you the embarrassing details because we know how shy you are. To everyone else in the bar, you've only been gone 10 minutes, but of course you and Josie know better. Then Josie pops out for a moment. In the meantime, you recount your adventures to the rapt audience at the bar, ending with the fact that you're not so sure the chocolate you returned with should be legal. It's that addicting. You also describe the Temple of Yuarian. Doc points out the reason for the similarity with a horrendous pun about what's Mayan is Yarin, but we'll skip that too. Josie pops back into the bar, more ecstatic than ever because she says, "We've done it." She tells you that Faxon chocolate is alive and well in the future, and the government had to make it a controlled substance. Kiss Colin keeps his word up to a point. As she explains, he dies in about 10 years, weighing it at over 1,100 pounds. They couldn't get him to a cemetery. They just cut a few strategic slits in the frame of his house, let his body fall down to the basement and buried him there. You feel great for having helped Josie, but of course your work from tonight is far from done. Alright, so that's another... So this is the hub of the game. Where you talk to people and do their, like, missions or whatever you want to call it, stories. I think we have to... I think this guy has a mission. And this guy. I think I'm going to do this guy. I might save this guy's for last. He's like an alien from far away. I forget who this guy is again. He's a cybergenic creature, so named because that's the drink we gave him the night he wandered in and told everyone that his race was planning on destroying Earth. But then we convinced him not to. I think I'm going to do his last. We already did the vampires. We saved the vampire. Who else? This guy. Maybe this guy has one. We can do this guy's. Noah Gonzalez is a senior man at the Suffolk County Bomb Squad. You saw him neatly defuse an exploding cigar and then neatly defuse the guy who gave it to him. See if he has a mission.
Yes, sir.
Let's see.
I've been to Brazil, Noah. I've stared death in the face and watched him play solitaire.
I can tell.
You mean because I have a more confident attitude and a more worldly wise demeanor?
No. Because you go into the jungle, you come back in time, and you must think your clothes go back to being as clean as they were when you left, but they're not. I can't believe you walked around the jungle in a flannel shirt. You're crazy.
Does this guy have a
quest?
Yes,
sir.
Up for any action?
You up for any action tonight?
Could be, but what you got in mind?
I don't know. Have you met the new guy?
Which new guy? I see several.
The one talking to Mickey. Now there's someone to arm wrestle. Look at the size of those four arms.
Alright, I think this guy had a quest. Let me talk to Squish.
Hello, human being.
So,
let's talk
how's
to him.
Things on the home world?
My world, very confused. Civilization there is... Wait, doing conversion. Is millions of your months old. Then, 3 weeks ago last Tuesday, we discovered beneath the surface of the planet technology far beyond ours.
initial thought is that planet is really spaceship disguised as planet. But when we entered inner core of spaceship, we find...
This is the part I like.
Inside spaceship is enormous asteroid.
Enormous asteroid? I don't know if I'll make that an alert.
The space bar?
I don't know if I'll make that an alert. Got some cheese. The space bar. Yeah, that's another one I still need to play, right? Hey, hit Marty.
So you thought you were living on a planet, but it's really a spaceship made to look like a planet, and the core of your planet is an asteroid inside the spaceship.
That is what we believed as well. Scientists probing asteroid now have evidence that asteroids only look like asteroids, but it's actually a spaceship of even more advanced race.
Huh. You'd think with all that advanced thinking, one of those civilizations could come up with something more original than making their spacecraft look like asteroids.
Yes. And the deeper you dig, the smarter you find out your ancestors were. You must be feeling pretty backward right about now.
I was not, until you pointed it out.
Huh? This guy?
Jake.
How's your love life? Predicting future events? Want to try the chocolate?
Want to try some homemade chocolate?
That stuff has no effect on me. I tried it once, years ago.
Maybe you didn't inhale.
Mm-hmm.
Jake.
Let's you and I go back to Casimir's?
Let's you and I go back to Casimir's someday, Mickey. You'd fit right in.
Why?
Well, nobody is average there. Everybody is exceptional. The tolerance for variety is probably at least as great there as it is here. Even better, I suspect.
Oh yeah, Casimir's was the vampire place, or the Transylvania.
Jake!
How's your love life?
Pitiful. Yours?
Hey. Who do you think you're talking to here? This is me. You know folk singers get all the girls.
No, but hum a few bars and maybe I'll remember it.
Do, do, do.
Yeah, Bill Clinton reference.
I need my water. Okay. Who has a quest? We need to find a quest. A mission. Our next mission. Not her. Him?
Hmm?
Doc?
Got any more of those riddles? I was just getting into the swing of them.
Sure, here's one. Same category, but a little bit more obscure. The clue is... penalized wages. Ripped. Gimmick, patriotic song, renowned inventor, display.
How long have I got? I can't.
How long
I need
have
to look
I got
at
to
it.
Solve it?
I'll be happy to tell you the answer after I've had my last drink of the night.
It's a rock band.
Hmm?
It's a rock band.
Got any more riddles? I was just getting into the swing of them.
Take a
sure,
picture of
here's
it.
One. Same category,
wages,
but
Doc.
A little bit more obscure. The clue is
Doc.
Penalized wages, ripped, gimmick,
Doc,
patriotic
tour.
Song,
doctor,
renowned inventor, display,
doctor, gimmick, I don't know the word, patriotic song, anthem, doctor, renowned inventor, Edison, anthem Edison, doctor something anthem Edison, display, I don't know. Doctor. What's a band with doctor in the name? Bands
with Doctor in their name. Bands with Doctor in the name. Doctor, yeah, I don't know. The category was, okay.
Give me a clue.
Okay, the patriotic song is an anthem.
Yeah,
okay.
It was anthem. Doctor, anthem, doctor something, anthem, anthemedicine display. How about this guy, scruffy man? He still doesn't talk to you? Longy Drink McGonagall? Nope. Shorty Steinlitz? Nope. Is it this guy?
Yes, sir.
Been to Brazil?
I hope you realize now that I am the champion.
You got help.
I swear.
Oh, we've already said this. That's about the riddle. They're talking about the riddle contest, sir. We did earlier.
You up
for any action?
I don't know. Well, if something exciting comes up, I'll keep you in mind.
Please.
Okay, maybe it is. All right, bartender.
Good job, Jake. You couldn't have done it without us.
So, what now?
What now? Well, that's up to you. There's a lot going on tonight.
Such as?
Well, let's see.
Did that.
Josie's all in a snit over something.
Did that.
See what that's all about. We've got the two drop-ins. They could probably use some chatting up.
Those.
Or you could go see what's keeping Piotr.
Okay, I'll do some talking.
Y'all
the two drop-ins. So that's these two, right?
Hello?
Right. Tell me about your race.
How'd you happen to wander in tonight?
For reasons unknown to me, this structure appeared on my monitor. Other Earth structures do not appear.
Your octagon?
This seemed...
Something with anthem.
Worthy of investigation. Perhaps it was a anomaly.
Not a chance.
Hello?
A lot of times it takes you out of the conversation. You have to go back in.
Tell me about your race.
Our
spin doctors, maybe.
Want
a cat?
Our
I don't like cats.
Our government is Chirp. And our chief exports are and what else would you like to know?
I don't like cats.
Why are you visiting Earth?
Squish's eyes began to dribble tears freely and small orange blots bleak out his nose and cheeks.
I believe you've embarrassed him.
Maybe they need women.
Good luck.
Squish wipes his eyes with the back of a claw.
If I explain, will you help?
There we go. Yes.
Yes.
Are you prepared to help me?
Does he have to decide right this moment?
No. I will be here for an indefinite period of time. You may inform me of when you are prepared to hear me out and help me.
I'm prepared. Let's go. Let's go for it.
Nope. Let's go for it now. Anything else I need to do here can wait till I get back.
You have a cat, Andrew? Squish's eyes begin to flow freely, this time probably out of gratitude. Whoever this guy's been sitting on, it's been burning a hole in his heart. Whatever he's been sitting on, not whoever. Hey, Marmot.
I've already podcaster told him battle about dress. The option, so he knows the routine.
Yeah, he just did a podcast. Press it for a DOS title? I mean, DOS isn't like... Like, a DOS game can be massive, you know? It's just how the game runs. I mean, DOS games can have voice and video and sound and everything. Everyone shuts up. Some of them recognize Squish's attempt to clear his throat.
To self-determination.
It's just running through DOS. I think this game was like 97, but it can run through different ways, methods, I believe. Kellan's Cross Time Saloon game. Yeah, the game came out in 97. I believe it can also, or it's pure DOS. Their engine probably just runs well through DOS, you know. You can have as much, it's not like there's limited on content, you know. He throws his glass to the fireplace.
Do I reveal now?
You don't have to say a word if you don't want to.
I very much want to. I come from a planet that your scientific community has not yet discovered. We have been keeping it a secret from your race For tens of millions of your Earth weekends, we have been observing the progression of your technology. You are now showing early signs of movement within space. The Zikrkitskrkbl are alarmed that your maturation is not commensurate with your technological ability.
Mm.
Your technology is used for the subjugation and the deflection of your own kind. This has not been our desire to impede your exploration of all that is beyond your planet. But we have attempted to lessen the aggression that remains within you. Within the orbit of your planet, we have situated an unoccupied satellite. The satellite emits a pulse. Targeted.
He directs a look of confusion at Mickey Finn.
Squish isn't too familiar with the language yet. The satellite he's talking about emits a pulse tuned to the molecular frequency of the hormone testosterone. Somehow, the pulse makes the hormone dissipate, though he himself isn't sure whether the testosterone undergoes a shift that renders it inert or lessens its effect, or if it is actually leached in some fashion from the human body.
Maybe that's why I've been a little off. It certainly explains why I've been a little less testy.
Oh, very funny. You couldn't even make a hormone with that one.
Why are you telling us about this, Squish?
Wouldn't be the first time we've had illegal aliens seeking asylum here.
I cannot refuse the will of the Zikrkitskrkbl. I, however, to retain the ability to speak out against the action taken against your planet. To my mind, subjugating a planet in the name of peace results in a false peace.
If you're looking for absolution, you're going to need to help us find a way to destroy that satellite. You know that, don't you?
I am here as its on-site installation technician. The interconnection of my mind with that of the Zikrkitskrkbl prevents me from overt interference.
Squish digs into a pocket and extracts something that looks vaguely like a keychain. He flings it to the bar, sliding it several feet away from him.
Oops. Now I have lost the key to my shuttle.
Squish, what would happen if somebody other than the, than one of your people took your shuttle? Could they destroy the satellite with it?
No. The shuttle offensive systems will not fire upon friendly hardware, but theoretically, if one were to dismantle the correct emitter circuitry and render it inoperable, the Zikrkitskrkbl might not be able to detect this. But if I were to find out about it, I could not help report it.
Well, I think I'll go outside, get some air.
You walk over to the bar. Squish pretends to notice some dirt under his claws. You quietly fold your fingers around the keychain and slip your hand into your pocket. Okay, we got his key. Okay, so he's going to help us destroy this satellite. Yeah, I think, this game doesn't really do anything crazy other than the voices, you know. It's all like sprite animation, you know, 2D animation. So it was probably like easier to just keep it as a DOS game within whatever however their engine works. That's my guess, something like that. Ash, what's up? How are you today? How you doing? DOS stands for display on screen. Pre-DOS computers printed out their displays on punch cards, which in turn was so-called because you'd give up and punch yourself rather than decipher them. You ever use a punch card slightly? You ever use a punch card, huh?
Think I'll go with you.
Oh, he's going to help us.
I'd be a better choice.
Oh, I figure I got more personal stake in this than you do.
Squish, about that shuttle of yours. Let's say someone were to steal it, heaven forbid. How would they operate something so foreign?
We are just talking theoretically, correct?
Naturally.
There would be nothing to be afraid of, even for a human pilot. The shuttle capabilities are minimal. The controls are obvious, so it may require some experimentation to understand their functions. The circuitry will not allow you to cause damage to yourself, nor take you beyond orbit.
Hey!
Let's be careful out there.
I'm glad he's possibly not coming with us, because the way he talks is, like, maddening. Okay. Do I choose who comes with me? Oh, are they both coming with me? Okay, the bomb squad guy's coming with me. All right, let's go. This seems like another cool mission. That's a very cool fact, Slightly. Thank you so much for that fact. This makes me want to go back and play some of the other Legend games. I think we might have to start playing some of the Legend text games. I can't stop myself. I really want to... Which one should we do? We could either do Time Quest, Gateway. Time Quest or Gateway. There's also Eric the Unready, but that's like a comedy, right? Yeah, humorous text adventure. Gateway is like a space one. I don't know how much this will spoil, but... Let's look at the screenshots. DOS version, yes. Oh, don't look down there. The Legend text games all have this cool interface. Gateway. Maybe we play Gateway. But let's look at, Time Quest. I'm not going to read any of that. Time Quest. Going through time? I mean, it could be alright. Time Quest could be alright. Time Quest. Or we could play the porn... or we could play, like, the raunchy one. Or we play the spellcasting ones, which... I don't know if... Hopefully, like, Time Quest and Gateway don't work the same way this game works. Where... with the timer. Though these games were pretty funny. And they were interesting when we played a little bit of them, but the timer is like makes them impossible to win. I really want to work through these games. I love Legend. What have we not played? We played Xanth Deathgate. We didn't play Hoboken. Shannara Missing. We played, other than their text games, we just haven't played Hoboken. I mean, there's Star Control 3 and then some Unreal Mission Packs, Wheel of Time and Terminator 3, but they're adventure games. We played them all. Superhero League of Hoboken is an adventure game, is sort of like an adventure RPG. You and Noah go to the parking lot. Barfy, thank you for barfing. I thought DOS stand for Disk Operating System. Slightly was making a joke. Barfy says DOS stands for Dumb Old Stupid. I know. Let's play some Call of Duty already on this channel. Jeez. Yeah, based on some books. All of these, is Time Quest based on a book? The game's based on a book. Xanth, Deathgate, Shannara, Callahan's Cross Time Saloon, John Sells, Blackstone Chronicles, Wheel of Time. They're all based on books. They made a lot of games based on books. Yo, Signal, thanks for the Prime sub. Thank you very much. Thank you. Ready for Time Quest? Go out, and you know I go out into the parking lot. And we have to find his shuttle. Where's his shuttle? Paka, thank you so much, Signal. Thank you for the 7 months. Thanks for supporting the stream. Thank you. Where's the shuttle? The station wagon? That's Callahan's car. That's a police car. Okay, that's Noah's bomb squad car. Drive it.
Hey, if you're hoping to get into low Earth orbit, you'll have to do better than my car. It's standard issue. Stays on the ground. Most of the time.
Okay, this Bel Air. That's Eddie. Eddie's car. Who's Eddie again? The Explorer? That's Mickey Finn's Explorer. The motorcycle is Josie's cycle. The old roadster is Doc's. This is my truck. Where do you say it? The Jeep? That's Joe's Wrangler.
Drive. Maybe we should take Squish's runabout.
I suppose. We won't get into outer space in my pickup unless it explodes.
Hey, only a dissent.
Yeah. Where's the runabout? Where is it? Did he say where it was? And I didn't pay attention. It's very possible. Go to the Route 25A. Don't see anything. Why won't it give me a runabout? The Unreal expansions are great. I still have never played Unreal 1 or 2. Oh, so they also made Unreal 2. Oh, that's crazy. I did not know that. I'm going to have to play Unreal. Maybe those are the next shooters I'll play. Unreal. Unreal 1 and 2. Okay, let's go to the Scott. Where'd he say it was? I missed where he said where it was. Drive the Bel Air. Drive the... Unreal 2's awful? That sounds good to me. The runabout? Where'd he say it was? I've never played System Shock, no. Leisure Suit Larry? Yeah, it's similar to that. It's like a raunchy kind of game thing. whatever word you want to use, raunchy or like, for lack of a better term, titillating. Then she sits down to her dad. Oh, it'll never happen. Never happened, Duke. Never happened. Titillating. Let's keep going with raunchy. Where's the runabout? I don't see it. Use the keyring. Ah, there. The ground trembles and a large spaceship warps into view. There we go. Ugh. I like bad games.
Wow, I want one of those.
It's just like very thin. Can we even fit in there? Get on the platform. Step on the platform. Noah right behind you whisks you into a shuttle. Get some animation. Animation. I have to raise the brightness since I'm like right near Windows now. I have to raise the brightness on. I actually have to raise the brightness on my monitor. Oh boy. Someone's doing lawn work. I'm gonna raise my brightness a bit. Let's raise it up to there. It should be good. Oh boy. That looks good. Alright. So now we're in a spaceshipy. This guy's spaceship, and you have to stop this satellite. The platform seals itself into the floor of the saucer. That's odd, you think. The saucer looks enormous from the outside. But it's horrifyingly cramped on the inside. The opposite. That race that created such a craft never learned how to properly harness the warping of space. Most races glom onto the fact that it's better to make something look smaller outside and be larger inside. Or they just simply never learned to pack properly. Noah walks over to one of the two seats in front of what appears to be a control panel. A moment later, when the vertigo of being pulled 50 feet into the air on a large serving platter with no visible means of supporting passes, you take the other seat. Meanwhile, back at Callahan's place, is Unreal 2, like, I mean, lots of games are bad, you know? Da, 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 da. Eternum's better than Unreal 2? Eternum, to me, was, like, unplayable. But, I don't know, there's different kinds of bad, you know? Imagine being titillated watching my stream. That would be too much. Avernum? Yeah, I've played the Avernum. I played the Spiderweb. I played Exile on the Mac as a kid, and I recently played Avernum 1, 2, and 3, the remakes. Yeah, Spiderweb software is great. Meanwhile, back at Callahan's place.
Do you think I could have told him how to work the controls? Nah, he'll figure it out. You think?
You see anything like a driver's manual?
Not offhand. Even if I did, would it be in English?
Good point. Think Squish would give us a driving lesson?
That might be a little too obvious for the Hive. We don't know if he can even get away with leaving the keys.
So?
So, we'll have to wing it. Squish did say it was idiot-proof.
Yeah, one idiot. There's two of us.
Seriously, I think we can pretty much do what we want. Squish said we couldn't really hurt anything, so let's poke around for a while and see what happens, and maybe we can figure it out.
Hey, you have the con.
Aye, Captain.
I forgot we have to play Red Faction 2. That was the other one. But someday I'll try Unreal 1, and then, I mean, you can always try Unreal 2. If it's just bad, you just quit. Alright, so we have to figure out these controls here. Forsaken? I have not played Forsaken. No, I never played that. So 2's unplayable. They just redid a Gene Forge, I think. Or they're redoing a Gene Forge, or it just came out. Look at redundant thingamajig. To you, this looks like a quantum state matter IO phase pump. Engage it. Press one of the buttons, and from deep within the shuttle comes the growl of a fuel pump.
Sounds like a 1970 El Camino.
You're playing Avernum? Yeah, those games are great. Those are, like, games that I would play off-stream. Because... I don't know why, I just feel like those are not streaming games. Maybe, like, the Gene Forge or something would be a streaming game. Not sure, I don't really know. I don't really know, but yeah, Spiderweb Software games, I love those games. They remind me a lot of Baldur's Gate. Just the overall feel of the game. Like the adventure you go on, all the different stuff you do, the side quests, and all the different fights you can get into. Unreal 2 might be a good stream. Unreal's lots better. Got it. I never knew that. You softlocked the mission, your mouse stopped working. I always thought Unreal 1 and 2 were generally the same thing. Just never played those. monitors. Look at them. Series of monitors keeps
flashing schematics.
Where have
I seen those schematics before? Hey, those are from GM's annual report.
I don't know what's more disturbing.
Turn off the monitors. Hell no, you have 10 shares of GM stock from the Junior High Young Stockbrokers of America Club. You want to keep half an eye on this. They're interested in toasted monitor. Turn it on. You push one of the buttons. A few sag, scraggly wires grow red and go out. As they do, you hear a human voice bellow the word Feminazi? I don't understand that. Hey, this monitor looks exactly like your TV did after the first time you watched Rush Limbaugh. Is that supposed to be a Rush Limbaugh reference? Open the storage locker. Oh, baby. Ava suit. Oh, baby. You pull the big, stuffed, bulky suit out of the locker.
My God, look.
It's still unwrinkled.
Hey, this really must be a superior race.
Yes, and it explains why they never had to learn to pack properly.
I like that joke that it's smaller inside than it appears outside instead of larger. Take the Ava helmet, pull the helmet from the locker, knock a few tiny multi-legged robotic spiders from it and carry it with you. All right, close the... Oh, let's be something else in it. You poke around the corners and find nothing but a few little scraps of the fiber carbonate frame from which the shuttle pieces had to be detached before being... assembled. Close this. I mean, this game's pretty amazing adventure game. I wonder why it didn't sell well. I guess it doesn't have as broad of, as an appeal because it doesn't play like a King's Quest. Row 2 could be boring. Yeah, that's you never really, you know, I mean, when I play games blind, you never know if like a game is going to be just plain mediocre. If it has any creativity at all, if it can still be bad. If it doesn't, and it's just boring, like, completely uninteresting in every way, it's no good. Pick through the garbage. With Noah hanging around, you're inhibited about your trash picking. So you kick it around a bit, eyeing it carefully to see if anything interesting turns over. Linoleo steel? Alien races are always able to combine Earth materials in ways that Earthlings never dreamt of or wanted. For instance, this here floor is made of linoleo steel, which has all the strength of linoleum, but is cold and rusts like steel. Thingamabob, what's this stumping brother? What do we got here? Fake palm leaf. Looking at the decorative strip of green plastic. Oh yeah, this fake leaf from the sushi. There are a lot of reading, yeah. I played some of Avedon, and I played mostly just Avernum 1 through 3 recently. The art of the skills? I don't remember the art yet, but I know this. I know how the skill systems are always the same in those two. Hey, John Matrix. Hey, Super Turbotronic. It's a very good point-and-click game, but it's like first-person kind of thing. There's a ton of writing, massive amount of writing. For the price that most Japanese restaurants charge for a two-piece serving of sushi, you can buy a pound of fish, and yet they insult you by serving fake garnish. Won't even give you a real sprig of the stuff. Is that cheap or what? Look at the Ava helmet. You regard the helmet with distaste since Squish's speech habits produce a good deal of spittle. But you can see the helmet snaps onto the Ava suit and that it's more than big enough for your puny human head. This is a four-armed Ava suit, other than the extra set of armholes. And it doesn't matter whether you use the uppers or the lowers. Neither set is at comfortable height. It seems pretty straightforward. I mean, look at the keyring. Squish's keyring features a holographic chip with his likeness, spiky green beard and matching teeth, sagging pulpy face, huge liquid eyes, and his four standard issue arms. It also has a small pad with a square button and a small tube of glowing fluid for finding your keys in the dark. Check the trash. You pretend to drop Squish's keyring into the pile, and as you retrieve it, overturn some of the bigger chunks. You find nothing. You're like... ashamed to look through the trash. eat some snacks. You pop a cheese flub in your mouth and the full rich flavor of irradiated cheese product powder melts in your tongue. That's why you love processed foods. No pits, no seeds, no worms, no unpleasant surprises, at least none large enough to actually see, except for the occasional finger or vermin portion. Search the can. Turn the can upside down. Not even a drop remains. Leads you to wonder what it would be like to have a prehensile tongue like Squish's.
I'm getting wet just thinking about it.
Okay. And get every drop into the soda can. Leaf through the magazines. The articles are short, simplistic, and amazingly similar. Within 3 minutes, you've finished reading 6 articles on how to get washboard abs in 4 minutes a day, 3 articles on how to trim your waistline in 5 minutes a day, 2 articles on how to get a complete workout in 6 minutes a day, and a quiz to find out if you're really cheating on your wife or just trying to revitalize your sex life. Like, how does this game have this much writing? In one scene, this game has more writing than entire other games. It's completely bonkers. And every time we start a new mission, I keep saying the same thing. Alright, let's initialize the Wutzis. After careful study of what appears to be the antimatter reflux monitor, you flip on what's certain to be the initialization switch.
What's that, Willy? You found a flight data recorder or so-called black box?
You love to watch the whole episode of Willy the Winsome Whale, but the game is afoot. Something or other. Oh, something or other. I thought it said something brother. You don't find any sort of on-off switch, but you stick your hand into the niche. Immediately, your hand is bathed in a weird light, so you pull your hand out again before it can be fried or removed or anything. Apparently, the only way to activate this device is to put things into it. The something other? Put this in there? You place the keyring in the niche. Once the flap is closed, a brilliant purple light fills the niche. At the end of its cycle, the light flashes green and then shuts off. You take the keyring out, but it seems unaffected by the experience. Oh. The fake palm leaf. Bright purple light fills the niche. You take the sushi decoration out and it seems slightly more brittle. The niche fills with a pale blue light. Once the light vanishes, you reach into the niche and pull out a duplicate of the sushi decoration. It lacks the beautifully artificial sheen, so you discard it and stick with the better of the two. Oh, we can duplicate. Can we duplicate the chocolate? You're not taking any chances with the chocolate. It has to last until Faxon gets that stuff into mass production. Duplicate the pencil. Put the pencil into the niche. Take the duplicate pencil, it's not as good. The eraser's crumbly. The lead's too thin. So I can duplicate stuff. But we still have, like, the morphine. We keep some things, so you must use these things at the end. You must use these items at the end in the last puzzle after you finish all the side quests. Okay. We can duplicate something else. Do we look at these books? You thumb through a dog-eared copy of the pop-up book of dog ears, but it doesn't hold your attention. Pop-up book of dog ears. Yo, magic eel, 100 bits. Thank you so much. Switch on the Veeblefetzer. You find what looks like the main toggle switch and flip it on. A grid of lights winks to life and you press buttons at random, hoping to achieve something definite. Finally, you do. Hey, you sunk my battleship. Okay, that plays battleship. Did we do the thing on the bob? As you press what looks like one of the more important buttons, the button suddenly loses all resistance, and your finger sinks all the way into the panel. You feel something clamp down on the finger, and then a sharp pinprick. You frantically pull at the finger, and a few panicky seconds later, the finger is released. You pull it out and find that you've bled slightly. Lights on the panel flicker for a minute, then a small window opens with an unlit pink bulb and a blue lit bulb. What? I'm confused. Hopefully the blue lit bulb means you're not pregnant. A pregnancy test? The hatch, can we open it? Reach out to the hatch for some way to open it. The moment your fingertips touch the surface, a high-pitched buzz suggests you're trying to do something you can't do. Maybe you can use the platform to enter or exit the shuttle, unless it's docked with a vessel. Okay, Whatsis override access. You punch a few of the buttons. You wanna watch a Fudgy the Whale TV show? I would watch that too. Did I ever play My Teacher as an Alien? No, is that a game? You punch a few of the buttons and a light blinks expectantly above one of the hoses. You unplug the hose and it squirts a bubbly brown solution at you. Quickly replacing the hose, you lift a drop of the liquid to your nose and sniff it, then you taste
it. Root beer, I think.
Alright, root beer. Emergency thingy, boot it up. Press a large button, the system ka-chunks to life and there's a loud hum behind you. You spin around to see a thick frothy liquid sweep over the front of the viewport. Two armatures, each with a thick black rubber-like edge pivot. And cut semicircular swaths into the froth. This happened several times. Now everything looks clearer. Alright, the secondary Veeblefetzer. You take a seat just in time to avoid having your secondary Veeblefetzed right before your eyes. Backup doohickey? We already did the who's he what's his override. The manual whatchamacallit, trip it. Trip what looks like the central switch, lights flash, and the buttons cease to have any effect. The backup doohickey. You access the main power supply, the unit begins to click. A moment later, a thin ribbon of smoke drifts out of a small grill in the panel.
Hey, new car smell.
Storage cabinet, we open that. You pull the cabinet door open. Inside are a pair of long-hooked gloves, which you take and then shut the cabinet door. Can we put these all together? Okay, so we got the Ava suit. If we need to go out in the, do we look through this garbage? Anything else in the cabinet? Just nano spider drones. Okay, so we've used all this stuff, I think. Redundant thingamadig. We already did that. I guess we should try, like, using the actual controls up here. Looks like we've looked at everything back there. A thingamajig, fiddle with it. Noah reaches up and behind himself and switches on the thingamajig. A small whirring desk, covered with some sort of hair, slides out of a slot and through the top headrest. Reaching a speed of 500 RPM, it buffs the nape of Noah's neck to a brilliant sheen before he even knows what's hit him. He yelps and pitches forward. The whirring disc, sensing its victim moved off, retracts into the slot, which shuts behind it.
Noah, I never realized your neck could be so alluring.
Take a number, bub. With this neck, I can do a lot better than you.
It's based on books. My teacher is an alien. I don't think I've heard of it. Okay, burrito, see you later. Have a good day. My teacher is an alien. Sounds like vaguely familiar, but... Bruce Coville's My Teacher is an Alien. I've definitely heard of this. Somebody told me about it a while ago. Let's check some screenshots. Can't find any screenshots. I've definitely heard of this. And I probably saved it somewhere a while ago. Oh, I read this book, actually, as a kid. I didn't know... Yeah, I remember reading these books. I definitely read these books. Bruce Coville's My Teacher's an Alien. The Alien Invasion Act... This was the book cover. Right? Yeah, I remember reading these books. This was the actual book cover. I didn't know there was games based on this. I'm gonna have to try to get them. There was multiple books of these, too. I remember reading these now. There. Did you see? Then there was also My Teacher Glows in the Dark. My Teacher Fried My Brains. Yeah, I read these books. I definitely read these books. My Teacher Glows in the Dark. My Teacher Fried My Brains. Yeah, I forgot all about these. That's cool that there's games. Try to get them. But then, look at this awful... oh my god, is this the modern version of the cover? Oh my god. Kids today. They just... everything sucks for them. Hey, Xenophone. This is the modern version of the cover. Or maybe it's for a cartoon. Maybe I don't have to be an old man yelling at the sky. But those old covers were so cool. Maybe it's just, you know... maybe that's what sells. This cover's so cool, though. It's, like, so creepy. Like, this cover's way better. Oh, My Teacher's an Alien! Ah! And the rest, like, Powerpuff Girls. Nope, that's the new cover of the book. Okay. I got these cocoa nibs. Okay, seatbelts. Look at the seat. It looks marvelous. Fasten seatbelts. You strap on your own belt. When Noah doesn't do the same, you lean
Pardon
over.
Pardon me, Jake, but I'll handle my own seatbelts, thanks. I'm not ready to take our relationship to a higher plane.
Is that supposed to be shuttle diplomacy?
Well, I think this is actually a good time here. So we're on ship 28. So Mondays and Tuesdays, I'll be starting an hour earlier and ending an hour earlier, ending around this time every day, but I'll be starting at 8 a.m. We'll be doing 8 to 3. I'll update my schedule under the profile so you guys can get used to that. But yeah, Mondays and Tuesdays, we'll be ending around this time, about an hour earlier than normal, but I'll be starting earlier to make up for it. Okay, so we're going to go. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for watching, everybody. Should be an old man yelling at something? I would love to be. I'm definitely old. Let's find someone to raid. Thanks for watching, everybody. Here's my socials you can follow. Pressure Grid Tom on Twitter. Instagram, YouTube. You can join our Discord if you want to hang out. hit the heart to follow the channel if you want to come back. And you can also hit the bell, turn the bell on to get Twitch notifications for the channel. Let's read Sinatar. Sinatar. We'll be back not until Friday. I am off Wednesday and Thursday. Normally resuming schedule on Friday. Thanks to everyone for watching, putting up with the missing streams from moving and...